Leslie Reefer Jr. says play, and here comes Superman with the first one. A little bit of shape to start with.
Very good delivery on target from Andrew Russell. He's got 10 wickets to his name, Russell. That's a perfect length on this surface. Just getting on to the top of middle and off.
Yeah, you talk about the glamour boys, don't you? You've got Gale himself there at slip. You've got Russell now, who was bowling. Then you've got Sangakkara back there too with the mitts on. He's keeping. And Shakib Alasana, Bangladesh. He's been one of the great all-rounders in white ball cricket in recent years. And then you look at Kesrick Williams, how he's been performing. Pretty good most of the time. First runs of the final. Smith is underway.
Yeah, he'll be a relief. Dwayne Smith. The crowd. Yeah. Looking into the action. As to the fans. Very pensive. Amazon Warriors, because this is their third final. They've just not been able to lift this title. Amazon Warriors. And well, the Tallawahs, their supporters will remember the victory in 2013. When they took down the Amazon Warriors in Trinidad.
That's right, yeah. This is a repeat of the first final, inaugural. Maddinson's first tonight. Gets a ripper! First one down! Little tickle, unlucky. Horror for young Maddinson. It is one for one here, courtesy of Russell.
Immediate success for the Tallawahs. It was a wonderful delivery, just angling away from the left-handed Maddison. Just fended at it a bit, and a simple catch to Sangakkara. Already celebrating. Maddison has to go without scoring. It's one for one.
Gun, and here is Chris Lynn, who's the leading run scorer in here, Hero CPL this season, and the highest aggregate of runs in the history of the CPL for a season. Chris Lynn is here. There's a little tickle, just a faint one, from Maddinson through to Sangers. There's that bit of inward movement. Saw a couple straighten, and now there's the one sliding back in off the seam a little.
He's been very controlled, Andrew Russell. This was the delivery. Wonderful length, good line to the left-handed batsman. And a delivery like that will trouble most left-handers. It was very early, his first delivery, Maddison, had to deal with that delivery.
Unlucky to nick it. Gale, you'll be watching this in slip saying, look out, we've got Lennon now. So come on, bowlers. One done, two for one here.
Early success for the Tallawahs. Seeing the back of Maddison. The Amazon Warrior as well. They'll be hoping that Lynn and Smith can take them to a very good total. They're not accustomed to batting first. And Amazon Warriors have won all of their eight matches, batting second.
Crowd rather animated because the first one is down now. Young Nick Maddinson gone for a golden duck. Caught Sangakkara, bowled Russell. Absolute peach here. So it was a little unlucky to nick it. It was such a good delivery. You often see those go past the outside edge. And now we've got Chris Lynn joining Smith. Both got off the mark. The first over only costing two and losing a wicket. Time for pace off the ball. Here's Ahmad Wazin. He was very cheeky out there prior to the toss. I'd like to see a change side. And it's not all about superstars, he was chuckling. But here he is. He's into the side and staying in the side to open the bowling. And don't bother running. Lynn in the house, and he's underway with a good boundary, very early doors.
He continues his fine form with the bat, Chris Lynn. He's blazed the trail in terms of aggregate runs in Hero CPL. And well, increasing the numbers every single delivery. A lovely shot.
Yeah, just been told. There's a misfield from the skipper himself. Gale with those big mitts, can't stop it. Yeah, he's over 450 now. It'll take him to 452 now for Chris Lynn. Having a wonderful time of it now that he's moved. Franchises. It's such a big blade, isn't it? And through the legs again. The old nutmeg.
Oh! Smith, on the other hand, he's been consistent as well with the bat. Three half centuries to his name. And the crowd here, well.
It's not a bad length. But, hurries on with the new ball. So such a skill, such an art for spinners to start, let alone the power play with only two men out inside the first six overs. But to bowl in these conditions with a new ball for a spinner, got to get it right, got to be precise. Now got Lynn back on, and they're fishing even here at Warner.
What Wazim has also done well, apart from his eight wickets, he's been very economical. His economy rate just about 5.6.
Oh, come on. Just wanted to wait and make sure there, Chris Lynn. So thick inside edge, he's going to keep the strike. Seven off the second, it's 9 for 1 now.
Quiet start from the Amazon Warriors. Remember their highest score in Hero CPL, just 166.
Has been underway for some time with this gentleman in the house at Warner. A hero fan of the match candidate for sure. All that different gear on. We've had some wonderful outfits around the Caribbean for Hero CPL 4. Here's Shaqib. Yeah! And here it gone! Big celebrations here! The Foo Fighters taking it! A cover! Big time!
It's all happening. The Amazon Warriors, well, they'll be disappointed. The leading run scorer, Lynn, just cut this one straight into the hands of Fu. Disappointing for the Warriors and, well, celebrations for the Tallawahs. Don't say anything. I've got it covered. Jonathan Fu takes a neat, smart catch. Get rid of the dangerous Lynn for 7. It's 9 for 2.
Thank you. star all-rounder. He can bat. He's coming at number four in the final. Sahail Tanveer with the fastest ever Hero CPL half-century of 18 deliveries is now in the middle. So the mixture of having a left-hander in the top there, they want that. Maddison gone for a golden duck. Let's get Tanveer out there is the thinking from Roger Harper, the coach, because we've got the left-handed Shakib on. Jonathan Foo. Got to keep it on the ground. Lin, you either go up and over or along the deck. In two minds, and it's cost him. Cost the Warriors big.
Yeah, Danny, this is really two big blows for the Amazon Warriors. Also, Chris Lin.
Very good at that stroke. And a race away. He's underway. Is Sahail Tanveer.
Wonderful shot. Not really risky, but executed very well. This one too straight from Shakib, hitting with the spin.
Just a fraction early, Lin. All it takes is a split second too early. The timing's not there in the placement, and then even where you get it on the bat, higher up on the blade. Change in the field now. There's a lot of waving going on from the bowler. So wants to be precise here, Shakib, because he's bowling in the power plot. Only the two men out on the leg side. Now, Tanveer is very quick to tell us in that interview that he has got the fastest ever CPL half century when you think of the big guns that are here.
Just a single. Well, Roger Harper, the coach, will be mindful of the fact that apart from Lin, Smith and Mohammed, no other batsmen in this Guyana Amazon Warriors team have scored over 100 runs in this edition. So a lot of reliance on the likes of Mohammed, Smith, Lin. He's not there at the moment.
One to go in the third for Shakib. It's a very, very good over to start with. Just five and a wicket, 14 for two here.
Pressure. That is what is being placed on the Guyana Amazon Warriors team. The Tallawahs, they've been unsung with their bowling, their out cricket. They've switched on for the start of this final. Madison and Lin back in the pavilion. The Warriors just scoring at over 4.5 runs per over.
Yeah, when you look at this Heroes CPL in this lineup here to night's final, the Warriors, Guptill had to leave to go on test match duty, and you look at the difference he could make, or possibly made, versus young Madison, who's missed out really. Got a 50 to Guptill, a 43, a 25, and a 23. So nothing outrageously fabulous from Guptill, but he was consistent. He was captain at the time before he left. So they had that lovely balance on the side. But a great opportunity for Nick Maddison. Quite able to grasp it and make the most. Here comes Keswick Williams. Into the final, and that'll race away. Fine leg up inside, not a great line to start with from Williams.
Second boundary for Tanveer. This one quite easy. Williams too straight, using the pace. Got the placement right. It starts a little bit too straight. That left-right combination proving to be a challenge already.
Of archers in the house, I suppose, with the Olympics on, DG, and they are warriors, so get the bow and arrow out. Oh, you be careful here, Williams. He's so good at that pickup too, Tumby. I know there's a man back there, but it is on that smaller side and hitting with the breeze. for the left-handed Sahail.
Williams hasn't really been that economical with the ball. He's picked up crucial wickets for the Tallawahs. 15 wickets to his name. Got a very good slow delivery. Quick short ball as well. Young fast bowler who hails from St. Vincent. Really led this bowling attack in the absence of Dale Steyn.
Dwayne Smith hasn't had much of the striker late. He's only on a couple from half a dozen. Leg cut there. Lovely cutter from Keswick Williams. Have to have all this variety. Doesn't matter your bowl, pace or spin, medium pace. Little cutter there. Yeah, good bounce.
What he's trying to do is stay very close to Dwayne Smith. Because he can be very dangerous with width on ball. Short deliveries. Dwayne Smith is very quick to pounce on these. Favours the onside. Long on straight through to deep backward square.
Yeah, the timing there. Oh no, it seems an age ago that August the 3rd, only you say 4 days ago, the first playoff between these two. And look back to that. They only got 146, the JTs. Tanvera got 2 for 24, and he got 21 not out. Crucial, 21 not out off 13 with a couple of big maximums to get the Warriors into the final in that first playoff. Wednesday. Wicked. Ages ago. Oh, no nick. It thought for a moment there could have been a little tickle there. Candidates, the El Dorado celebrations for this year's Hero CPL. Wayne Parnell, he's not here anymore. DJ's gone home as well, but he's a heck of a mover and groover. And Keswick, who's on at the moment, with the dancing shoes on galore. Oh, and there's a bit of width. He's got, well, he's got four. It could have been worse. Ends the fourth, nine from it, 20, 3 for 2. Three for two in the final. And here's the rest of the El Dorado celebrations. Cottrell, Gale, thinking of dear Bubs. Back live now, Shaqib. Oh, and that could have been number three. As it is, the outside edge has gone for four. Time for Messrs. Mato and Haseman.
Daniel, thanks very much. So interesting start this for the Warriors after being invited to bat. There's a couple of things we need to discuss here about the start of this final. You can see that ball just holding up a little bit. Seen a couple of deliveries do that on this surface already. Move pitches from the other night. 27 for 2. Shaqib came to the party in the last game, picked up 3 for 20. Which made him join the league. Hasn't done too much with the ball. The ball, that one again. Let's just keep going with those El Dorado celebrations. That was Superman just the other night with that 42 ball 100. Outstanding stuff. Again. Expecting some turn. Tanvir not there. Superman picking up a wicket this time and getting some CPR. That's away. That's nicely played. Tanvir likes to deal in boundaries. Four he's got out of 18 balls at this stage.
Quality shot. Not much turn, but picked his moment and picked his field of where he was going to go. Certainly going to need a big innings tonight from Tanvir. Early trouble, early wickets.
By the way, the winner of the best celebration, the best El Dorado celebration, will be announced in the presentation after the match today. This evening, I should say. They might have a few more to add to it throughout the final. I'll be surprised if we don't. Nine from that over, 32 for two.
Good over. The Warriors there, nine runs, a couple of boundaries. Tanvir and Smith in early. Early wickets in the power play.
So the average score batting first here is 170. We're on a slower surface today, so that should have been dropped by certainly 10 runs, maybe even more. I don't think Chris Lynn allowed himself enough time to get used to the surface after the form he's been in, because that's a big blow, Mato, and he went.
He's their main man, isn't he? But as out there for the toss, before the toss this wicket, it just looked a bit drier. Cracks were a little bit more, and you felt that. Just something different to the yellow wicket we'd seen. But for Lynn and what he's done so far, and the partnerships with Muhammad as well, 350s he had to his name, and we had him in that pre-show, and tonight wasn't his night. Disappointing. Russell now.
What about this bloke? He's just a sensational. What a cricketer. Bat or ball, he's full of energy. Strong. He released he could do some rapping. He released a song recently, which is called This Is Where the Party's At. It's quite apt.
Certainly is over here in the Caribbean. Smith, though, I think we've seen him. He's already, you know, he's got a couple of hundreds in the CPL already, playing at the Barbados Tridents. He was now over to the Warriors. So he has the talent and the power to do something special at the top.
Oh, that's going to be a little bit of a medal in the rib cage. You might have picked up a little bit of a yelp from Dr. Smith. He might need the doctor.
That's the slower delivery. Roll the fingers across, short. It's always going to tickle in there. Don't rub it, though. Don't rub.
Right in the breadbasket. He won't change his game. He doesn't feel nerves at all when he's batting in the middle. Dr. Smith just plays his natural game. I don't think he'll alter too much. He'll rely on some support from the other end, of course.
I think what's important for them, the Warriors, as a batting group, is not to think of something like 200. It's just post a score that you can put pressure on Gale and Russell. So we know the average score. Even if they get to that, they need to post something.
We go down the ground, that's why long on's in position. And the problem they've got, of course, after Tallawahs winning the toss is eight of their wins in this edition of the CPL's batting second, so this is pretty foreign to them. Their highest score batting first is just 166, the Warriors, so it's different.
And the two times they have batted first, they've lost. They've lost both those games. They love batting second, and they would have been looking at that toss today go up and came down the wrong way. Chris Gale won it, decided to bowl first.
The other tricky thing is they will know that the Tallawahs are weaker in their bowling. The They've got Russell, Lyon and Williams. If they don't do the job, they're in trouble. So they will think they would need to get more than the 170 to put some sort of pressure on the likes of Chris Gayle and Sangakkara. But no, it's not a good start.
Well, what's been the hard thing is those 2 wickets, isn't it? 2 wickets in the first power play and one of them Chris Lynn. That takes away some firepower for them to get above that 170 mark here at Warner Park.
That's whipped away. It's just going to be the one, though, so it's keeping things in check. Very much so, because only 2 runs off that over. 34 for 2 off 6.
End of the power play. 2 wickets down. Tanvir. Now at the moment, 19 off 14, trying to build a partnership with Smith.
So just to continue that chat about the Warriors and the fact that batting first, highest score is 166. The Tallawahs have scored more than that on 5 occasions. So as soon as that coin didn't fall in the favour of Red Emirates, there would have been, you would imagine, a couple of alarm bells just going off. Some silent ones, but they would have been there.
They'll love to bat at second. Tanvir loves bowling first as well, with all those wickets in the power play early on. Would have been all over Chris Gayle. Not to be tonight. Different tactics. Just trying to get their field right. Chris Gayle taking their time as they always do.
So 3 for 23 in his last game, Shakib, and I don't think he really has done the job expected up until the finals week. And I guess if he gets that right, that's all that, that probably matters now.
A little testy now with Smith. You know what Smith want to do? You want to hit to the shorter boundary straight down here towards the commentary box. Shakib will probably change his angles. He'll go around the wicket. The right-hander, see there, mid-off, it's a deep point. And the usual, the short, fine leg, and the man out on the square leg, boundary and deep mid-on as well. He's just trying to get his field right, trying to work out where you're going to bowl. It's about length to Smith. I think you've got to be very careful how full you're going to bowl.
He will like this wicket, Shakib, as well. It's a track that is stopping a fraction, but there's no real evidence to turn at this stage. So he should be able to, in these sort of conditions, just tie Smith down. Except for that. Bang, there's 6. That's broken the shackles. You can see him itching to do that, Smith.
Hero Maxman just spoke about what he was going to do when he faced spin. And this is it. Wasn't a bad length delivery, really. But he just gets under it and he rips it to the leg side.
There is protection, so that's just going to be the single. Yeah, he's one that likes the seam as coming on the bat more than the spin, the Smith, but he played this beautifully.
I think he just backs himself. That's the idea with that size of that boundary. I've seen a few go up on the roof last night. Russell was putting several of his 11 sixes up on the roof and outside the ground.
It's going to be on the bounce. Just the one, though. So a bit of turn there, and Tanvir not getting hold of that one, Tony. He was going a lot straighter than that.
That was good length. Had a bit of flight to it. Did Tanvir in the air, and he drags a leg side. Was lucky, didn't time it too much.
solid. Just for one, so that's a nice round 10 runs. Off that over, 44 for two.
Nice little partnership now, 35 off 30. Tallawahs easily winning the toss and deciding to bowl first, like Chris Gayle. Russell, a couple of overs, one wicket. Shakib as well, amongst the wickets.
Even though Williams's first over was on the expensive side, he's someone who picks up wickets. So I wouldn't be too concerned about nine off his first if I was Henry Gayle. Oh, goodness me. Who's that, Marta? You know all these people.
I'm not sure, is it? Bit of a mixture. I've got a Wolverine hands, but the rest of the outfit, I'm not sure.
The Batman going down there at the top. Oh, careful. Oh, God, he's going to poke his finger in the eye. That would have made a bit of a mess. Thomas now to start his first over. Passed around the commentary box. Howie can't help us. Danny can't help us. Tom Moody can't help us. There's some Guardian Group volunteers who were standing next to the Wolverine stroke Batman man. Always nice to have the volunteers around the place. Always very helpful. They've done a terrific job throughout the CPL. See, we had a nasty incident at one of the early games here where the Patriots home games, one of the volunteers got smacked. It was a bit of a glancing blow just in the back of the head while she was just taking care of some duties, but she was okay. That was the good news about that. His scoring shot, it's where he likes to go all the time, Tanvir, giving the opportunity. Generally more airborne than that.
And that one, it really shows the wicket. It's good at the moment, as what we've seen is a bit of two pace, it's drier. So maybe it will help batting first. You never know. Team batting second, chasing a bigger total. If they can get there, they can get 170 above.
There's a no ball, so Thomas has overstepped by John Ward with his helmet on, calls that. So now we've got a free hit, which is a captain's nightmare. Good luck, Chris Gayle. He can't change the field. Oh, goodness me, that's over by a long way.
Yep, that's definitely a no ball. And that's the facial expression you do when you know your captain says, well, I really can't do much now. Free hit has been given. Can't change the field.
There we go. There's Andre Russell just moving his mark back a pace. Generally, what you do with a no ball is you move it forward half a pace so that you don't overstep. That's the general consensus. Russell's moved it back. It's going to be a wide, so it's still going to be a free hit. So there's a couple of extras creeping up here. You might remember the Warriors had a massive problem with the extras in the last game, 21 of them. Tallawahs are in check at this stage.
Also, what that does is all of a sudden a big over, isn't it? Get your batting going. 15 plus and an over. No ball.
Oh, it's a bottom edge, and it's good work by Sangakkara. That would have been four if it hadn't been as good a keeper as Sangakkara.
Did well, saved three runs. I was going to race away down to the fine leg boundary. Moved well to his left. Sangakkara. Good work. Got a piece of it.
So it's a long over. Thomas is first. So that no ball would have put a bit of extra pressure on him. whipped away. There is protection. Now we've got a check we're going to hand over. This is Pete Russell, who's handing over a check to Minister Richards, who's receiving this on behalf of the St Kitts and Nevis National Education Foundation, which invests in public education, preparing the nation's children to learn and thrive. Good on you, boys. Thanks, Pete. Thanks, Minister Richards. Oh, that's gone high. That's gone very high. There's a man lurking. Should be taken, and is taken. Thomas has picked up his first wicket. Fowler's camping on that for a long time, but importantly, he's done the business. So that's another big blow for the Warriors.
Great piece of fielding. That ball went high into the night sky. Never easy. It's the slower delivery. Roll the fingers across. Smith hit it straight up. This is a quality catch under pressure. Well done. Three wickets now. The Warriors are in trouble. Smith is gone. 317 tonight, and they're 50 for three.
One of the things I wrote down before this game got underway, the big final, is the Warriors need Smith, Mattinson and Lynn to fire to break their finals jinx. All three of those guys are now gone. Jason Muhammad, however, is a very fine player and has done a good job for the Warriors, and he is seriously needed tonight.
Yep, this is another big player gone. Lynn, now Smith. He's had the potential to score quick runs. This one went far too high, but that is a tough catch. It might look easy, but coming out of that night sky and so high up, how put it under pressure. That's not looking good if you're a Warriors fan. Smith's gone for 17, Madison no score. Lynn, single figures, that's pretty rare for him this year.
It's down the leg side, so he's going to have to bowl that one again. Just want to give you some more information about that. St Kitts and Nevis National Education Foundation. It's going to provide a deserving disadvantaged student with an opportunity to receive an excellent education, and so far 42 recipients have benefited from money donated by the CPL. $23,000 has been donated, so that's good stuff. Terrific cause, nice work. There's no doubt they're in trouble. Four down. We've just completed 8 overs. 52 on the board.
Big crowd in the house. Did yourself bring the beat. Bring the beat, as it says on his cheek. He's going to be hard to beat, I would have thought. They get a Digicel gift pack, which includes a phone. An old mate beside him with the goat horns on. He's enjoying himself at the cricket. Not enjoying themselves quite so much are the Warriors, who have lost three big wickets early. Mattinson got out for his first ball faced. Lynn, rare failure. Only single figures as we welcome Darren Ganga. Interesting stage of the game, Daz.
Yeah, you're right, Howie. Amazon Warriors not in a good position. What I like about the Tallawahs is they've been very clinical with their bowling. They've had clear plans. And they've really executed well as a bowling unit.
pitch that we started on when we first came here at the start of the finals. A touch slower than the one we played in the last couple of days, a touch harder to score on, Des.
It appears so. We saw Dwayne Smith just before he got out struggle a bit to time the ball. Deliveries that were very short proved to be very easy to put away. Once there were deliveries on a good length, run scoring was very difficult.
This man though, Muhammad, 6 not outs, second best average in the competition. He's often steered them to victory with those 8 wins they've had batting second, but tonight it's a whole nother story. Nice crowd in too. Big shout. Shaqib loves it, and that's why. Muhammad, he has to go. Not out tonight. Big wicket. Shaqib gets his second, and the Tallawahs, they've got their tails up. Look at the crowd.
Another danger man down for the Warriors. This time, Jason Muhammad hasn't really troubled the scorers as yet. This delivery, well, hitting him in line was that angling down the leg side. Shaqib, he was convinced. So to the umpire, Leslie Reefer Jr. It's all happening here. The Tallawahs taking control of this game. Muhammad goes without scoring. It's 53 for 4.
Big wicket. Another look at that. Barnwell comes to the crease. Just a top scorer of 16 in the tournament. Big job. Wouldn't have been expecting to come in at this stage. Muhammad, that first ball. The man that's been so hard to dismiss. All right, Daz, let's have another look at that. Was it sliding down leg or not?
Let's see. With the angle as well, one would think that maybe going down, yep. Convinced.
That's a great over. A wicket and just one run from it. The Tallawahs well on top. 9 done, 53 for 4.
So lots of success for the Tallawahs with the ball. They've picked up 4 wickets. Really contained this guy in Amazon Warriors team. Ruskin opting for lots of slow bowlers within the first 9 overs. It has accounted for Smith, Madison, Lynn and Muhammad.
See the tail of the tape for the Warriors. They played each other 3 times in the tournament, twice in the home and away where it was 1 game each, and then in the first playoff game, Warriors won that by 4 wickets. Beats the outside edge. Gee, they're under pressure now, Guyana.
Good areas from Thomas. This was the dismissal. Correction, this was the previous delivery. It's not been very, very consistent. Thomas, this was the big wicket. Muhammad leaning forward, not getting bat onto this delivery.
It's a wide. Big job now, Darren, for Sahail Tanveer. Unexpectedly coming in high up the order. He's got the job done with the ball. 20 wickets. Now he needs to get it with the bat. What type of score do you think they need to scrounge their way to that gives themselves a chance?
At this stage, I think they can get close to 150. It will be a great effort for the Amazon Warriors. They still have players who can bat a bit. The captain, Riyad Emirates, is no slouch with the bat. You have to work hard for every single run.
Bit of confusion in the middle. Barnwell, touch of sleep there, but they get through for a single.
The problem is when you have players at the top of the innings doing so well consistently, doesn't really provide for an opportunity for the low order. And it's the final, and the Guyana Amazon Warriors are relying now on their low order to give them runs.
In some ways, the partnership of Lin and Muhammad, they've been a victim of their own success now, haven't they? Beautiful night here. It's been raining on and off in St Kitts, but today was glorious early morning. No breeze about now. It's a beautiful evening for cricket. Barnwell gets to get off the mark.
Well, it's the climax of this year's Hero CPL. Everyone's keyed on, switched on. The owners of the Tallawahs sitting very comfortable at the moment.
Love their cricket here. As soon as we came into the country, customs and immigration straight away said that they were here for the cricket and they'd be here for the final. No doubt they are. Tanvir on strike, one on the leg side. Sitting in a hotel right next to the water. Was out for a swim this morning, Daz. Saw you. I don't know if you were just coming home or whether you're out for an early morning swim. Which was it?
No, it wasn't me, trust me. False alarm.
Rumour you may have been doing some line dancing somewhere last night. Any truth to that? Or is that the Lockie, our scorer beside me, was he? Oh, my Lord.
Roger that. You got it right.
Yeah, well bowled. Really well bowled. Need to hurry. Almost got to switch on a bit here. He's here in a final. He's got an opportunity to make some runs. He's got to be right to go.
Yeah, just under 10 overs being completed. This was an opportunity. He's safely home in the end. Every single delivery will count. It's a final, and they will need to play out their best. Amazon Warriors batsmen.
A slow one, they hurry through for a single again. So the Tallawahs are right on top after 10. The Warriors, who have already lost two finals in the past, are 59 for four. Superman, he's ringing the bell with helmet on and some pretty rude pants, it must be mentioned. It's time though for a Buster drinks break with the Tallawahs right on top in the 2016 Hero CPL final in St Kitts. 59 for 4 from 10 overs at the Warriors. It's finals time where you need to bring out your best performances. And for mine, this man here has been on fire. He's been the best Buster drinks operator we've seen. He's a cross between a Marcel Marceau, Michael Jackson, maybe a touch of Danny Morrison thrown in there as well. He's been quite fantastic, providing all sorts of entertainment. We mentioned how nice St Kitts is. This is the place where you need to come for a holiday. And one of the places you might want to check out on the slopes of Mount Leomega is the Catition Hill Resort. 400 acres, 18-hole golf courses. Well, have a look at that. A little bit different than the hotel we're staying in, it must be said. Beautiful views of the ocean. Caribbean on one side, the Atlantic on the other. There's a golf course designed by the Welsh wizard himself, Ian Woosnam. Luxury villas. Why haven't we been staying there, Darren Ganga? You're the king of the West Indies. Why haven't you sorted that out for us?
Lovely place here. Maui. We'll probably get there one day, but lovely views of St. Kitts. Wonderful island. And if you're into your golf, well, it's the place for you to be. Park Life.
Some wonderful golf courses in general around the Caribbean. All right. Wazim comes back into the attack from the pavilion end. Tanvir holds the key here. It's a man out at deep backward square, deep mid wicket. Deep straight and deep point.
So this stage is really about consolidating, not losing any more wickets. Guyana Amazon Warriors look to try and build a base from which they can accelerate maybe in the last two overs. On the other hand, the Tallawahs want to continue getting wickets.
Keep rotating the strike here. Barnwell's 2 from 5. He's got to get a single at least. Get things moving.
Wait. Good line, good length from Imad Wazim. We spoke about his economy rate. He's been very good keeping that pressure on the opposition.
Less than 6 and over, 8 wickets for the tournament, so less than a run aboard. And look at this, in the 11th over of a final, he's bowled 3 straight dots. Something's going to happen here sooner or later. It's another dot. The pressure increases on Barnwell.
He can't afford to play so many dots. There's not much turn. Should be something that Barnwell should do. Gather single.
Outfielders need to be ready here. Sliding down leg, but 5 straight dots, 1 from it. Great over, 60 for 4.
Two overs, just conceded 8 runs. Wazim, Chris Gill, he's made the right decisions so far with his bowlers. Taking control of this final. There's a couple of skyscrapers, and I've seen a couple of low scoring overs as well.
Here's the captain of the Warriors, Rahat Emirat. Tanvir throws the hands at it.
Tanvir moves into the 30s. Just 28 deliveries, so we have a lot of work to do. Still a fair amount of batting to come. Bramble, Rahat Emirat, men who are all capable with the bat.
had a chance to chat with Andre Russell at 3 o'clock this afternoon, Daz. And I said, how are you feeling? He said, good, I only woke up at 2. So I don't know how he managed that, but he was full of beans.
And you would have remembered the game between the Tallawahs and the Trinbago Knight Riders finished at 3 a.m.
Big shout across the line, the big swing.
Confident appeal by Johnny Ward. Thinking it's possibly pitching outside leg. Let's have a look. Yeah, just outside that area.
He was also telling me, Andre Russell, I've spent enough time in the Caribbean, I should get myself some bling. And he advised one thin gold necklace and one big thick gold chain, Daz. Way down the leg side. Yeah, you'll see a bit of that on social media over the next month or two, but I'm not sure I can pull it off, Daz. What do you think?
I guess it's a matter of preference. Bling can mean anything at all. And some of these cricketers usually like their gold chains, fancy sunglasses,
diamond earrings. I'm not sure how I'd go back in Melbourne with diamond earrings and two gold chains.
Bling for you might be a surfing board.
That's exactly right. Haven't found many waves here in the Caribbean. Wrong time of the year. There's man. He likes a bit of bling. Been posting Instagram with him and his young daughter. The sodded dad. Barnwell, he needs to get going. 3 from 10.
Not a good over being stacked up by the Tallawahs. Shane Thomas made his debut in the last game. He's picked up his first wicket in T20. He's done a good job in this Tallawahs bowling lineup.
So since Barnwell came to the crease, just 10 runs from 19 deliveries in total. Pushes through for a single. So, in a bit of a hole at the moment, the Warriors, 64 for 4.
Has gone 64 for 4 now. Real trouble here for the Warriors. They've got to try and do something. They're going at just over 5 and over. It's just really got off the back foot, and these girls have been pretty busy celebrating the Tallawahs' performances. Wales being lifted off at the last moment. Spinners certainly just sliding things through at the moment. Not allowing too much air with these short, straight boundaries. Oh, there we go, Caribbean Airlines. They've been zipping us around the Caribbean. Nice to have them on board. CPL. So the runs have dried up. Barmore has not got going so far in this edition of the CPL. Just 62 runs. Has a reputation as a big hitter. He's clubbed that, and it's gone for 6. So there you go, they need more of that. They have no choice, the Warriors, but to try and get some big boundaries going.
Oh, Barnsley! Bottom hand, loving it. Need a heap more of these. There's Guardian. Group catch for cash, it could have been. Should have been, no! Are you kidding me?
Cries of catch picked out Chris Gale. So they've got another one, the Tallawahs. Real problems here. One blow from Barnwell, the next one he just hauls out of the skipper.
It's
Disgust from Roger Harper, the coach in the dugout for the Amazon Warriors. And the Warriors fans in the crowd, heads down, says it all. Just fatted one over the fence for six. Now, bottom of the blade only for Christopher Barmore. He makes double figures and makes his way back to the dressing room. It is now 70 for five.
Ideally, they need another 80 runs, and I'm just not sure where they're going to get them. Bramble's only scored 61 runs so far in this CPL. It was the guns at the top that had to do it. Smith, Lynn, Madison, they're the guys had to get the runs. Tanvir was expected to chip in, but he's holding things together now. That's optimistic. Sliding down the leg side.
Very keen. Madwazi. Shakib's got one to go his way. Certainly missing. You can see where Sangers are gone. Sangakkara way down the left side.
Yeah, they've had one roughie already, so they certainly didn't need another one. Oh! Gone. That's out. Wow. The Warriors have got to be worried. Six down now.
Well, they're going to have to believe it. This unlucky 13 for some. We've had 13 overs. We've only had 70 runs, but now we've got six wickets. Say the Tallawahs in this grand finale. Hero CPL 2016. There's another duck for Bramble. See you later. It's 70 for six here.
So the skipper's arrived now. So the skipper's in, and will they get out of jail? Tanvir's on strike. And he's played a mess. If they continue at the same rate they're going at now, at just under 5.4, they're going to get just over 100 runs.
Two and an over. Very hard to bounce back there when your top order's gone. And all of a sudden, Anthony Bramble tries something extravagant in the 13th over. He's gone. And he faced two deliveries.
Six runs off the previous over and also two wickets. I'll tell you one thing that is very noticeable at the start of this game. And the Warriors, yes, they had a couple of days off and won that first playoff and straight through to the final. If you compare the body language, the activity from the two teams, right from the word go, there's no doubt the Tallawahs were more switched on, they were more active out in the park, they were buzzing a lot more. And that's not necessarily something you associate with a team led by Chris Gayle. I wonder if Paul Nixon had something to do with that, because he's like a energizer bunny.
Yeah, you interviewed him, didn't you, recently? At the hotel just a day or two ago. Again, we brought up this argument in tournament situations, and particularly now this Fast and Furious format of 2020. See it in the IPL. If you finish top, you win that first eliminator, you go straight into the final, but you've probably got, what, 4 or 5 days off. You're not playing any cricket.
Oh, that's worth a bit of a shout. Singakara's gone up once. I think Chris Gar went up a couple of times. And they're a little bit shocked by that, the Tallawahs. They reckon that was adjacent. Leg by is given as well.
Well, the skipper wanders across. And I just wonder if he got so far across. Oh, I reckon that's a very good shout. If there's no woodwork from the bat in hand from Rad Emirate, I reckon the heights are right too, Mikey.
It was given a leg by. That is Salmon Trout out. Down the ground. Brilliantly fielded by, guess who? Superman.
Andre Russell. In the thick of it, he's probably done something else to him. He's always groveling around the parks all over planet Earth, whether it's the IPL, the Big Bash, the BPL, here the CPL. Wonderful effort this. Well, you expect it all the time now from this bloke.
And I mentioned in the build-up too, Danny, wherever he's played around the cricketing globe, you speak to the owners of the franchise. More important, you speak to the coaches and some of the younger players. They say behind the scenes he is just extraordinary. Spends so much time with the youngsters and the Nets, passing on his knowledge. It's whipped away, and they're going to pick up a boundary. Gee, they need that.
Well, he's holding things together here by the skin of his teeth. It's Sahail Tandir, 37 from 34. That's his fifth boundary. Here's the LBW shout. Oh, he's got a cross. You can see leg stick as well. No wonder they're all testing the lungs.
There's the boundary. So eight off this over, one ball remaining. They need another boundary. Straight down the ground. Superman's lurking. Is he going to fly? Oh, no. He's made an error. Keep that tape. You just don't see that with him. It's gone for four at the end, 12 from it, 82 for six.
Now you don't see this that often. Full of commitment as ever, Andre Russell. He's always going to struggle to stop that one. In the end, it just gets under him and gets away from him.
A dozen off it. There's a look at what he would have been concerned about, Tanvir, at one stage when he saw it was going near that bloke. But he was caught between diving and trying to get the body behind it to save the boundary. A foot short, I guess, in the end. And a quick chat with the medical boys as well. But he's still on the pitch. And still prepared to do some work for the Tallawahs. So Emirate, the skipper. He's only faced the one delivery. Hasn't got off the mark yet. But he's a very good cricketer, this guy, right, Emirate? I've watched him for a dozen years. I've been very impressed with the work he does with both bat and ball. Oh, goodness me. Unless he steps outside his crease. A wide is called, but that's okay. You get stumped off a wide. Another one goes down. What is happening to these Warriors?
Ah, oh, you know it. They're on a roll and a half here, the JTs, courtesy of Sangers. Sucked in down the leg side, right, Emery. Ahmad Wazim, that's all as good as gold with the foot, anyway. Sliding down here. And, well, he went out to get the milk bottles and then the door closed behind him. Emers, you got to go, son, early. Oh, another duck. Seven down now for 83.
So Wazim's picked up 3 wickets for 15 runs off 3 overs. That first ball was a wide, but he got a wicket with the last ball of his last over. So this is a hat-trick ball. Kumar's letting everyone know that as well. Now he's realised, so he's asked for a catcher to come into the covers. Jacobs has arrived at the crease. Hat-trick ball. Easing that one. Nice and fine. Coming back for the second.
Sharp piece of bowling in terms of the dismissal to Raed Imrat. Slides it there. Sangers is alert to the situation. These two could have got together, keeper and bowler that is, get together. Let's slide one down the leg side early here, Sangers. And then we'll hopefully try and produce this sort of dismissal.
It looked like it might have been the case, actually, because he just got down there so quickly. And he was so smooth in his collection of that ball. It was Kumar Sangakkara. Not much going down there with Stephen Jacobs in the batting department, coming in at number 9. Tanvir, meanwhile, is still there at the non-striker's end. Straight to the band, no run. See, the thing about the Warriors throughout this entire edition of the CPL is they've just got things done. They've had steely resolve. They've got things done. This is so out of character. Really is. Losing 2 inside 4 overs. Outside the line that time. Shake of the head there from umpire Reefa.
Now they're into the engine room now. Jacobs at 9. All of a sudden there's just 10 and Jack to go. You can see what I mean. Wazim's trying to do. Nice and straight. Slide it on in. No turn. Just get it full. Look for the LBW bowled. Simple as that when you're bowling to the tail.
There's only one thing that they can do now, and that's try and get Tanvir on strike and get Tanvir to try and hit some boundaries. There's not that much of a breeze tonight. There's normally a big easterly that comes through this ground at Warner Park in St. Kitts and Bastia. Sliding leg side. There's a bit of shouting going on for the moment from the Tallawahs. And why not? Jacobs is getting a little bit agitated by things. Where Sangakkara ends up. Not going to miss it, though. So a wicket off the first ball, which is a wide, so it's a long over. This is the extra delivery. And now there's a couple of little games being played by Wazim, and why not? There's no doubt that Jacobs had a little bit of a go at him, and some words were exchanged, and now Wazim's decided just to slow things down a bit, get him thinking. Sangakkara darted down but went too far. That's going to end up, I think, off the bats, given us runs. 89 for 7.
Full house in here at Warner. And they're enjoying the occasion so far. Wickets galore tumbling down in the 2020 final.
Nice to see plenty of support in Warner Park today. She's full of smiles. Warrior supporter. Still hoping for the best. There's the work that Imad Wazim has done. Superb. 3 for 21 off his 4. That's outstanding. Really good work for a final with 16 dot balls.
Top draw. It's pumped. And again, it brings up the argument about going straight into the final and having days off and not having to play and keep that edge, that playing edge about you as a team, rather than just playing net training, the odd open wicket practice. It's just never the same with a match with all the stuff riding on the playoffs. Tallawahs had to knock over TKR the other night.
It's just going to be one. Yeah, there's no doubt that's something that's discussed. The other side of that coin, Danny, is the fact that the Tallawahs had one of their big stars, Andre Russell, in big trouble fitness-wise in Fort Lauderdale. So then performing and winning and giving a couple extra days rest gave him the benefit of coming to this game pretty fresh, I think, apart from when he hurt his finger recently.
He said, look, I'll just show you how well I can bat. Oh.
There were thoughts that maybe the Tallawahs might have peaked too early in this tournament because they had that 10-day break before they played in Fort Lauderdale. And after that, things went downhill and they had to do it the hard way to get to here. But, gee, they'll be ecstatic with the scoreline now.
Yeah, perhaps underlining, when you have that big break, you lose momentum in terms of just match play, simple match play.
Good Williams, he's had to take over the mantle of the wicket taker. He was the only one actually who performed since the home games in Jamaica after they lost Stain, who was their big star. The rest of the guys, the wickets were few and far between them. Not that long ago that Andre Russell bowled four overs and went for 64 in Florida.
Was this guy, Kedrick Williams, 15 wickets. He's come to the fore and he's making the most of the fourth edition of the CPL. Yeah, I've liked his action. I want to chat around the Caribbean. You want guys with a bit of zip again. Top of the tree. Can Sahail supersede that and go to the top? He's doing it with a bat at the moment. Can he do it with the ball in the Tallawah innings?
Oh, he's hit that high. Now, there's not too much breeze, not too much wind tonight. And it is well taken. Fu it is who's taken the catch. Williams, we've seen that a few times before. They are on fire, the Tallawahs.
Oh, Johnny Fu, where's the Foo Fighters around the ground? The music should be all over the PA system. Jonathan Fu. Difficult catch, those steeplers, and when they drop on you, with the big dark sky of the night, not easy. Lovely change up from Williams and Jonathan Fu. Lovely study of concentration, eyes on the ball the whole way. And then it's back to the dance floor for Williams. Brilliant. Top score is gone for 42. It's 91 for 8.
Down, two balls left in the 16th. Pamal is at the non-striker's end. Jacobs is on strike. Got another one, Williams. Watch the celebration. Catch him if you can. Two and two balls. They are all over the Tallawahs.
Ah, smoking. And let's get the vibe and the moves out for Johnny Fu, courtesy of Kedrick Williams. High fives and the party started already here at Warner. Oh, she knows it. Jacobs is going to have to go courtesy of a Williams special. Wide of the crease. Didn't get off the crease, Jacobs. And the Olympic sprints are on already. Ah, oh, yes. Love it. Jacobs gone for 7. It's 91 for 9 now.
He's got 2 wickets and 2 balls, so he's on a hat-trick. Another one on a hat-trick. Wasim was on a hat-trick not so long ago. 9 down, 1 ball left in the 16th. They've only made 91, the Warriors, after Tallawahs won the toss and elected or asked them to bat on a surface which is fine. It's a bit on the slow side, but it's absolutely fine. Nothing wrong with it. Zampa now at number 11. Real chance for hat-trick here. Leg slip. Bit of a gap there between bat and pad, but enough willow to ease that on the offside for one only. So 2 wickets and 3 runs off that Williams over. Sensational stuff from him. 92 for 9.
Can't believe it in the Warriors dugout. 92 for 9. Zampa, who can actually bat a bit, but at 92 for 9, Damien Martin. Well, we're clutching at straws as far as positives go.
Yep, it's a bad night for the Warriors. Batting first is never their thing. They've lost 2 games by doing that already in the competition. And look at that scorecard. Not good.
Movement in there as Russell comes back into the attack. Zampa aggressively hunts a second. Oh, I think he's in big trouble. Sangakkara likes it. The Warriors may well be all out. Keswick Williams, who's done the job with the ball, he's in the outfield. He's got a rocket arm.
Fantastic throw to East Sangakkara. Let's check. Bat is in the air. Not sure, Zampa, why the bat is in the air. Once again, we see bad running. Slide the bat. I find that it's very hard to believe at this level of cricket. That you're getting run out because of that. And what a night for the Warriors so far. Gale wins the toss. It's a ball first. And then all of a sudden, they're out for 93.
Keswick Williams choosing to dance right in front of Adam Zampa. And that's what Zampa's giving him a mouthful about. Probably a little bit early to celebrate. Sure, they've knocked over for 93. Not sure you need to dance and prance in front of the opposition batsmen as they leave the ground. This is the lowest score ever for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. He's a feisty character, Adam Zampa. And he wasn't impressed by that, and probably fair enough. Zampa's referring to his arm position in the bowling attack, so it's starting to get a little bit heated out there, but at the end of the day, Damien Martin, only 94 for the win.
Yeah, it's not good at all. They haven't won a final yet, and they cap it off like this at the end, which he would have been in, Zampa, if he slid his bat. See there, he just has it in the air too much, and Sangakkara, Paul Nixon was coach in the first year when they won it, the Tallawahs, and he's back at the moment. They won the toss, they sent the Warriors in at the top. Smith went, Madison first ball, Lynn no good tonight, Tanvir was the only good sign with his 42 off 37, Muhammad no runs, and it continued all the way down, a disaster, and all out for 93.
All right, let's get straight down onto the ground with Darren Ganga.
Thank you very much, guys. I'm here with the man of the moment, Imad Wazim. 3 for 21, your best T20 figures. How did you enjoy that?
It's wonderful. And in the final, if you do that, that's even more better. So I was waiting for a long time to get 3-4 wickets because I know I can do it. So it's a great moment for me.
Your thoughts on the pitch?
Oh, it's a great wicket to bat on, to be honest. It's just when Linney hit me for a boundary, I was like, oh, it's a great wicket to bat on. Still, it's a good wicket to bat on, slightly on the slow side, but I think it's a great wicket.
Before the start of this game, did you ever thought that you'd be chasing a low target score like you've had set by the Guyana Amazon Warriors?
No. it's straight no. You know, you get the team out under 100. It's a great achievement in the finals where the pressure is on. Yeah, but I think we bowled really well. We feel it really well up from Russell and Chadwick and Shakib bowled brilliantly. And it just if you play to your potential, I told them before, if we play up to the potential, we can beat any team we want.
And I know that you're a proud man about your bat, and you think you'll have a chance of doing something with the bat today?
I hope they send me up, but no, it's just we have a great batting lineup, so it's fine. I want to show the world what I'm capable of. I will show it in some other day.
Congrats again, and well done. All the very best.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
A stunning performance by Jamaica. They won their four games at home at Sabina Park, and they lost three on the trot in Florida and here. But have a look at the bowling figures there. Wazim, 3 for 21. Shakib, 2 for 25. The dancing Kedrick Williams, he's had a brilliant night. 2 for 12, 1 for Thomas, and 1 for Superman at the top to get it all going when he knocked over Nick Maddison. So, a target. Unbelievable. But the target for the Jamaica Tallawahs is 94 to win with the likes of Gale, Andre Russell and Sangakkara. Stick around. The Tallawahs will take chase next in the Hero 2016 CPL Final. Nearing the end of the 2016 Heroes CPL, still a chance for you at home. Play on Daily Fantasy CPL, $10,000 guaranteed. Play now at playon.co. Get yourself involved. Well, highlights time. If you're a Warriors fan, maybe close your eyes now because there's not many of them. First ball, Nick Maddison faced. Bang, snick, straight to Sangakkara, and Maddison realised he was gone. Lynn got an early boundary, looked to be good. He was 7. Off 9 deliveries then, hit it straight to the man at point. And Fu took a good catch, Shakib got the breakthrough. So Sahil Tanveer came up the order and started pretty nicely. He was the only one that really got going. DR Smith was watching wickets fall. A couple of little edges. They were struggling along. Tanveer tried to get things going, a little bit inventive. Smith went the aerial route with a rare hero maximum. Then he went high in the air. Rodman Powell, who's had a wonderful tournament for a young man. Thomas took his first wicket, and that was a good catch by Powell. That was the end of Smith for 17. And at this stage, the Tallawahs really had their tails up. Mohammed, first ball, the man that's been not out 6 times, he was gone. And from here, Guyana lost 6 for 23, if you can believe it. A couple of lusty blows. Barnwell, he really got held up, though. Inside edge straight to Chris Gale. And then Bramble, first ball straight through him. He was knocked over. They just couldn't do anything right. Tanveer was doing his best to try and get it up towards 100. In the end, they weren't even able to do that. Andre Russell with a rare mistake, tried to take the catch, went to the boundary. Good work from Sangakkara. That was the end of the skipper, Emirat. Another duck alongside Bramble, Mohammed and Nick Maddison. That was called off the bat for 4 runs. And then Tanveer, Jonathan Fu, had a brilliant night in the field. Tanveer the only one to get any higher than 17. And Kedrick Williams was dancing around again. Jacobs, well, he couldn't keep out Kedrick, who was on a hat-trick at this stage. Look at him, he can't believe what's happening. It's a bit of love to Johnny Fu. And then Zampa, off the inside edge. He came back for a second, Adam Zampa. He was caught short, Sangakkara with a run out. Zampa's bat was actually in the air at that point. 93. All out. Damien Martin, for what has been a wonderfully consistent, well-balanced team, it's extraordinary to see them bowled out for 93 in a final.
And maybe that's just the pressure of the moment. They like batting second. They've lost 2 games and they batted first. And I think for them, when you lose wickets early and Maddison, then Lynn went, and Lynn being their leading run scorer and their main person, I think it just went down through the batting line, didn't it? They lost confidence.
Yeah, it was those middle order players that had been exposed to very little cricket. So what do the Warriors do? what do they do, Mato? What do they bring to the table now? Can you, in any possible way, defend 93?
Well, you can. I mean, that's the thing. They are a chance, but it's a very rare chance. The odds are it'll be very hard for them. But Tanvia, they'll need early wickets. They just have to. They have to use that new ball. They're going to have to go hard in the first six overs. But it just hasn't been Roger Harper and the Warriors night tonight.
All right. They can't believe it. There's Zampa. There's compatriot Nick Madden. Let's have a look at some of the wonderful catches that have been taken throughout the tournament, Mato. There's been some absolute beauties. These are the Republic Bank Classic catches. Jason Muhammad has taken the most wickets from non-keeper in the tournament. Made brilliant ground to take that one. Plenty of brilliant catches in this tournament. Adam Zampa, he's got a couple of inches. That's one a backward square, gone like a rocket. And he's taken as if to say, well, that's what I do all day, every day. The young leg spinner. Sangakkara with glove in hand. That was at Sabina Park versus the KKR. A brilliant effort by Kumar Sangakkara. This is a real good one out in the outfield by Ahmed Shahzad. We thought he'd hurt himself there. Grabbed his shoulder, but a brilliant catch.
It was a brilliant catch. Diving to his left. We had some great catches. It's been a high standard. Zampa is in it. Classic catches a couple of times. The one behind square leg and now the caught and bowled. That was a lucky one off the wrist. He managed to hang on to it. Great standard of everybody. Devjit straight back. One-handed, similar to Zampa. Just put the hand up and it's in. Crazy that was in Florida. All these ones in Florida when we were there. David Miller, he's a superstar. T20 cricket and he's fielding. And he moves quick. That's what he does well. He gets in position quick to where he thinks the ball is going to drop. And he just loves it. And he's back-to-back for him. Over there, diving forward from mid-off, running in. Always difficult. Moved once again into a good position. It's a fine package of some great catches.
Yeah, Miller with a couple. Keswick Williams, the man of the moment, just sticks out one paw and says, thank you very much. That's a brilliant effort. Keswick, who's had a great tournament. Nice El Dorado celebration. All right, the winner of that will be announced later on tonight with all our prizes. The Republic Bank Classic catch. Who's your vote with Damien Maher? You were called to vote upon a couple of days ago. Who do you think?
Not sure.
Don't give me a not sure. Give me an answer.
No, I'll come back to that. We'll work it out. I'm looking forward to seeing who the winner's going to be. Who do you think?
Anton Devjic, I think, sticking out that four, followed closely by Keswick Williams. There's a big crowd in the house. Instant kids tonight. She's stoked. She's on camera. They're moving and grooving. Sunday night here. Beautiful evening. But just 93. So it's been a tough night for Warriors fans. Everyone's been enjoying the halftime show. Have a look at this fella, Mato. He's pulling some smooth moves out on the floor.
Got a few Darren Ganga moves. Dancing away, singing. Fantastic. Even Danny Morrison, he'd love to be up there.
No doubt he would. They're dancing in the Tallawahs dugout after the break, led by Chris Gale. They'll be chasing 94 to win the 2016 Hero CPL final. So Chris Gale, the universe boss, walks out in the middle. It's a very small target to chase down, just 94 to win. So Tanvir and co are going to need to get a bevy of early wickets to take you all through that. He's a wonderful combination, Darren Ganga and the incomparable Mike Haseman.
Thank you very much, Howie. The big man, Christopher Henry Gill, start proceedings for the Tallawahs. He has done a good job with the bat for the Tallawahs. With a brilliant 180 scored against the Trinbago Knight Riders. Spoke about
retaining the fastest CPL 100.
Well, the game is going to be right here in my book. Walton is going to be facing the first delivery. Gale will play his normal conservative game for a little while first up. But here's the man. He strikes in the power play. Got 20 wickets so far, and of those 20, 9 in the power play. So he's going to have to get a few, simple as that, a few in his opening spell. He's picked up 8 wickets in his first over throughout this edition of the CPL. And he only goes at 5. So he's got all the numbers, but he's got nothing to bowl to.
Brett Emmert, the captain of this Guyana Amazon Warriors team, will have a lot of things to think about. How could he get 10 wickets? Give himself a chance of winning this final.
It's a spar. Sliding across Walton. Yep, that's what he should have done. Let that go. No need to take any risks whatsoever on the surface. 94, that's all they need. In a final, in a big final, to win the trophy for the second time, the Tallawahs. For Chris Gale to be the winning captain for the second time. For Paul Nixon to be winning coach for the second time. Ripped away comfortably. That's just a couple of bounces, and that's gone easily for 4 out of the middle.
Walton has been a silent performer for the Tallawahs. He's been overshadowed by the likes of Gale, Russell, but he's been very effective with the bat. Before this game, he would have amassed 276 runs. Well, counting. Wonderful boundary to get off the mark from him.
They need wickets. They've got one catcher. That's a slip. That's all they got. I guess maybe a shorter extra cover, not a short extra cover. That's not going to help the cause. Wide called by umpire Reefer. I think we can safely say the Tallawahs are favourites on the Unibet live odds.
Played by Walton. He's got 2 half centuries to his name. Missed out on a century. Got to 97 and couldn't quite convert.
How they're going to use Adam Zampa. He's been one of the trump cards of the ball, but normally when they've had numbers to bowl to.
Three dot deliveries. I also feel that when you're looking for wickets, you have to create the right environment to get wickets. One good way to start is obviously bowl a lot of dot balls. A man who has done that very well, Stephen Jacobs. Economy rate just about 5.2. He's done a good job. That's the man for this Guyana Amazon Warriors bowling unit.
Slow all that time from Tanvir to finish the over. So first one gone, 6 for no loss.
Required rate just about 4.5 for the Tallawahs to clinch another CPL title. Won the first title in 2013. And this man, Chris Gale, steering up another victory.
So here's a look at the bowling hot list. Stephen Jacobs, top of the pops. Sunil Narayan, he was outstanding throughout the entire CPL. Good to see his artistry. Tanvir, 130. It's all about current form.
And the reason why he's in this hot list is not really because of his wicket-taking ability. He only has two wickets to his name, Jacobs. But he has created a lot of pressure because of that number there. 5.2 economy rate.
Yeah, it's a package. It's about current form. It's about wicket-taking as well. But if you're someone who's really economical, you are a hot-list bowler or a hot-list batsman. Right, Chris Gayle on strike now. How's Gow going to play this? We're talking about the fact that he'll probably settle himself in like he normally has been. He's the sort of guy that, who knows, he might just start teeing off from ball one and try and get this done quickly.
I don't think he's in the type of form that we've seen from Chris Gayle in T20 cricket. His last three occasions got into the 30s. Didn't quite convert. And we've seen him very watchful and cautious at the start of the innings.
Had a crazy start to the CPL. First five matches, 251 runs and an average of 125. That's just quite ridiculous. Including a magnificent century against the Knight Riders.
Oh!
Big broad bat. Two men allowed outside the circle at this stage is a man at deep mid-wicket and a man at long off. Hard, but it's too straight. Every chance actually of that going for four because long off is so wide. Thankfully for the Warriors, the stumps got in the way.
Yeah, this was hit firmly by Chris Gayle. Cannon into the stumps. And that's why you see umpire John Ward with a helmet on. It's a dangerous position to be in. And guys like Chris Gayle on strike.
Oh, yes, Jets.
So this is good work from Jacobs. One run off four balls so far. Normally, batsmen would start to get agitated. But they don't have to. They can absorb a few overs here. There's no real dramas. Definitely pad first, but outside the line.
Agreed. Looked like outside the off stump on first sighting. Let's have a look. Pad first. Definitely outside the line. Confirmation there.
Oh, he's hit that, Miles. That's a beauty. What a shot. What a way to get going for Chris Gayle. That is his 100th CPL 6. 450 up for the tournament as well. Beautiful stuff from Gayle. 13 for 9 off 2.
Chris Gayle, he has announced himself. Mighty hero maximum. Like I said, he's not been in the best of form, but knows when to switch on. Real opportunity here to secure another title.
Tanvir. See, what about this connection? Last ball, the first five deliveries were good. Last ball just disappeared. What a great shot from Gayle.
Didn't look like a big aggressive stroke from Gayle. Such a powerful player he is.
Oh, just going to be, no, thought about one, but didn't take it in the end. Of course, this finals week is in St. Kitts. It really is a beautiful spot. Some outstanding beaches as well. It's a lovely island to just zip around, and also Nevis, let's not forget Nevis, just across the bay. It's terrific, really is quite special. Lovely waters, white sands, beach bars all over the place, and it's a tourist haven. Right, let's go downstairs and get a little bit more about this from Danny Morrison.
Yes, thank you, gents. Well, I'm with the Honourable Lindsay Grant, who is the Tourism Minister for St. Kitts and Nevis here. Tell you what, very excited to be back here. How good is it? And how are you loving having the CPL back here?
We're very grateful. As you can see, we have an electrifying finals, ramp-packed crowd, standing room only. And so we're grateful for it.
Yeah, and it's been quite an initiative, too. I remember 2 years ago, had the finals here in 2014. A little bit of a surprise to get it late here, but I tell you what, you and I love it here, don't we, Sideline?
Well, I love it, and I know you love it also. So we're happy to have you back.
Yep. And in terms of this initiative, you think it's really helped attract people to this part of the world in St. Kitts and Nevis?
Absolutely. I mean, our name is out there, right, front and center. So we are grateful for that. I mean, millions of people are watching the game tonight. Over the last 4 days, we've had wonderful cricket. And so we expect, although it's not a big score tonight, it's going to be a wonderful game of cricket.
And Lindsay, you're an exceptional MP, because I know you've actually been in the party stand with the crowd here, mingling and getting amongst the whole fan base.
The atmosphere in the party crowd is electric. I mean, you can see the atmosphere tonight. Everybody's partying. Everybody was here. I mean, I drove around at 5 o'clock this afternoon, and people were coming in already, excited to have a wonderful game. And I don't think they're really disappointed this evening.
A short one, no run, is it? Oh, hang on. They're going to get a run here, Lindsay, I think. Just the one. But, oh, look, thank you for your time. And for all of us here, look, we're just going to rock on over to the party stand. Thank you, Lindsay. We won't go back, eh?
We just want to make sure they come to St. Kitts and Nevis the next time around, because I think they're having wonderful cricket, wonderful country. People are fine, historic nature. I mean, St. Kitts is where you want to be.
Oh, I'm not coming back. I'm staying down here.
That's great.
Thank you, Danny. Thanks very much, sir. Gale on strike. Now, the Warriors are called bat. Let's see how much they can get stuck in here and try and get into this lineup for the Tallawahs. They've got to play like true Warriors tonight. One run off that over. That's good from Tanvir. 14 for none.
Three overs in the power play. Completed. Remember, the Amazon Warriors, after six overs, they were 34 for two. Tallawahs really not in any hurry, as their required rate is just about 4.7 at the moment.
Wherever we go throughout the Caribbean with the CPL, there's always truckloads of Warrior supporters. Guyanese are all over the place. They love their cricket. Always come in and watch. They're going to have to scream and shout today. Really encourage their team to see if they, first of all, can get rid of these two openers, and in particular, Gale. Walton's on strike at the moment, again, to the spin of Jacobs. And then as soon as they get one, they're going to have to try and pick up another one quickly, like Kumar Sangakkara. 38 days we've been here with the CPL, this edition of the CPL. Oh, that's it, yes. 38 days, and it's been a delight to have Hero on board. They're on board for another couple of years as well, so great to have them. They make terrific motorcycles. Always nice to have a brand like Hero involved in cricket, as they are in many other parts of the world. A little bit of a swipe that time, but he's hit it well. Just trotting through for one.
Yeah, he just felt that Walton was looking for the aggressive stroke. That is what happens when start building dots. Usually most batsmen looking for that big shot, and that's what the crowd wants to see.
Funny rap, funny rap, funny rap. after that six from Gale, it's forced a bit of a swap. He had a long off, a wide long on, long off in position, and now there's a swap over to long on. I think it needs to be about 30 rows back, though, from where he is now, bottom left. That would have given him a slight chance of catching the previous six. Quicker, no flight whatsoever.
Yeah, you're right. Hasn't really been able to extract a lot of spin from the surface, Jacobs. Even saw that with Imad Wazim. He's only getting the ball to angling as a left-handed bowler. Jacobs not extracting much spin.
Oh, bottom edge that time. Slight fumble, wouldn't have made too much difference anyway. Gale was down that end pretty smartly.
Bit of a fumble in the field, allowed for a single. Just three runs from the over so far.
That's clubbed, and that's clubbed out of the ground. Another fine shot from Gale to finish the over. It's a second time in two overs. The last ball from Jacobs has gone for half a dozen. So nine from that, 23 for none. The skipper is worried.
Gale lining up this power play at the moment. Tanvir continues. It's more runs. It is just a bad night for the Warriors at the moment. Gale's hit two big maximums. Now Walton getting into the action, and good to see Danny Morrison. You've ran back up here.
Well, I nearly didn't get back here. Hell of a party sideline here at Warner. How's that? The tourism minister getting in with the constituents on the mound with the sponsors. And this one's disappeared too, up into the sponsors' ear. Stunning part of the world, St. Kitts and Nevis hosting the final, the fourth edition, Hero CPL, packed house. And you could say, look, just a shame that they're not trying to track down 180 and make it tight, but hey, that's cricket for you. Having a ball.
Unless you're a Tallawahs fan, Danny, then you are very happy. That's the perfect night. Won the toss, decided to have a bowl, and then you bowled out the Warriors, the lowest score ever in CPL history. That's made a lot of people happy. Paul Nixon, one of them, they won it the first year. And this is what happened, look at this. They love the joy, the happiness. Get on the big screen.
Jumping, jiving, bouncing all over the place here on the mound. Stand and deliver from the stormy one.
Perfect for Chris Gale. Chasing the second title for them. Paul Nixon and Chris Gale joining back forces this year after the first year when they won. And he's got a great team at the moment full of superstars. Sangakkara, Russell, Williams. It's been fantastic. Powell as well.
Little change up from Sahail. He normally bowls maybe just an over or two and then gets out. And he's been getting wickets. Has Sahail Tanvir. Nine of his 20 have been inside the power play. And then he comes back at the death. But because they've only scored a paltry 93, Sahail Tanvir, he's going to keep trucking on here. Into his third. 10 dots. Needs to rip out a couple of poles. Same juncture. The Warriors were 32 for 2. Can they dislodge the openers here, the Warriors? Not looking likely at the moment. Solid as Walton and Gale.
10 wickets. It's going to be tough going. See that in T20 cricket. 65 after 91 deliveries now. 10 wickets in hand. You can just tell by the energy out there, the facial expressions, they know this is one of those finals, one of those nights where everything's went wrong. Madison, first ball, caught behind. All started from there, bang. Then Lynn comes in. Lynn's gone early as well. And it's snowballed.
Misfield from Chris Lynn. You never see it. Horror night for the Warriors. So five done, 30 for none.
So if you're a Warriors fan at the moment, you'd be a bit disappointed. So well, they've played so well at home. They won three out of their four games and got into the final. And just... it really counts. Messed up tonight.
Great vibe if you're a Jamaican fan. It's a great initiative here that you wore your Patriots replica shirt. The first 500 got in for free for the final. Here in St. Kitts and Nevis. First 500 are in for free. Only holds about 6,200 here, jammed in. And they've come along for Sunday the 7th. Jacobs starts his third.
Yeah, good crowd tonight. They've been coming in all dressed up, all in their colours. We've seen some great hero fans in the outfits. And it's been good. Come in for the final. I might be thinking of a different final. It's certainly been action-packed. I'll not complain about that. He's missed out, Chris Gale, short. No bounce and almost at the toe of the bat. He's going mid-wicket, he loves mid-wicket.
So I'm not going to miss this one.
Mid-wicket. Amrad, even he knows. First one didn't bounce. He missed it. And this one he got. Right out of the middle of that big Spartan bat. Flying into the crowd. He's changed his shoes and he's got some luck going, Danny, now. Gale Force is gone.
This one, back-to-back maximums. Talk about a hero, it's Christopher Henry Gale here.
The perfect night and the perfect game, the final. 2016 CPL is seeing this. It was Russell. It was Russell in the game before to get him into this final. The quickest 100 ever. Took it off this man. And it's continuing tonight.
Two to go in the sixth. Power play nearly ended. Goes downtown. Just short of another maximum. Big, big over looming here. 17 off, one to go.
He's had enough. He doesn't want to be out there too long now, Chris Gale. He wants to be celebrating. Get back in there with his team. Stand and deliver. Almost triple. sixes at the moment. He keeps going. 17 so far.
He's keen to finish it off. He's bought up 400 runs for the CPL this year. It's 47 without loss.
A little bit of tension. That's what happens. You won't get much out of Chris Gale at the moment. He's doing his job. That's what he'd be saying to Walton as well. Let's just finish this off. Good partnership. Let's chase these runs down and get off this park.
Start in the middle, and then he just pitted away there in Florida and just prior to that to Chris Gale. But he's still brought out 400 runs for the Jamaica Tallawahs. Now there's a bit of chat going on, and Johnny Ward's popped in there just to calm things down. Walton won't buy into it. He'll just say, hey, listen, Jakey, check out the scoreboard, brother. Total control here are the Tallawahs. None down, looking to just get to 94. Zampa now. Power play done and dusted, so they bring on Adam Zampa with his wrist spin.
He's done very well. 15 wickets this year. It's the first time he's in the CPL. I won't remember this game tonight.
One knee, comfortable, safe shot. Mentioning Mato, yeah, slower surface this side of the square compared to the slicker side of the square here.
Yeah, moved across, it's a little bit drier. I'd say inconsistent sort of pace coming off the wicket, but when you watch the Tallawahs bat, you wouldn't think so. Zampa has done fantastic, always getting wickets. We saw those classic catches as well. He had two of those and then 15 wickets as well, so great signing for them this year.
Have to bowl that again, and I'm just looking at him here. Does he produce that googly, that wrong-in early to the left-handed Gale? Gale, 30 from just 15, four maximums. And he likes the look at this one. That's this, baby. She's gone miles. Another maximum to bring up the half century with a team score, courtesy of the captain.
50's up, the seventh over. Chris Gale continues, five maximums now. Russell had 11. It is a powerful batting lineup, this. And Zampa knows he got it wrong. Bowled the googly and it still went. Gale's going to keep going.
Jacobs has gone up. No one else has. He's got plenty to say as Stephen Jacobs.
Not when you're losing. That's probably the area to bowl. Sliding and going across Gale. Get Gale cutting. Don't want him going mid-wicket way or straight down the ground.
Too short! Jerry, see you! See you later! I love this game and this guy!
They kept getting bigger and bigger. Two hero maximums this over. Gale has six so far to his name. Everything's on fire tonight. 88 metres. We've seen 102 metres be hit. Getting bigger and bigger.
One to go. Zamp has been slashed away. That'll run away as well. Big over two. Back-to-back biggies. 18 off the seven. It is 65 without loss. Gale running away with this final. Hero CPL 4th edition. They won the inaugural one. And if you're short and wide, well, too easy.
Good placement. Used the pace of Zampa and ran away. What an over. I think 46 of 19 deliveries. Put him and Russell together, and you've got a force in the batting lineup.
So Walt, he's got a turn to face the music, and it's going to be Brad Emmerich. Captain has brought himself on. He's used a lot of spin, pace off the ball. And a chance for him in this final to show his wares, his class with his cutters. Certainly a class haircut from the barber recently.
Yeah, we were disappointed taking over from Martin Guptill. He went back for test duties from New Zealand. He was the captain of the Warriors early on this competition. Emma's taken over, done a good job. He'll be feeling it at the moment. Always do when you're captain.
Decides to come around as Emma up against the stormy one. Got everything in control here. 28, a truckload of deliveries left here. Funnily enough, he's at the top of the tree. Chris Lynn is playing in this final. Way back on 27, and Russell himself 23, and that's why the Tallawahs are in this finale. Big Blay just needs to lean on one and say, back over to you, Chatters.
Well, I think he's picking the other end with a spin. That's what he'll be deciding to go for. Take Zampa on, use Emmerich, knock him around, unless something really gets put up there that's in his zone. I think he would like to be there at the end as the captain. Should be nice. I reckon there's big odds of him hitting a six to win. He's hit enough of them.
Yes, please. That's a bold. It's typical Emmerich. He's probing away on off stump. The little one that jags back or goes a little bit off the seam with a leg cutter. It's that body language of the Warriors. So frustrating. Runners up. Twice already, and now they're going to be runners-up three times in 4 years. Only the fourth Hero CPL. They've been in three finals. Not a good feeling for Roger Harper and Co.
Well, the only positive is that they have been very consistent in all their CPLs. They would like a win. Getting there three times and the shake of the head from Roger Harper. It's been a bad night. That happens in sport. At least they've got there. They've given themselves a chance. They'll be looking for answers afterwards as well, but just haven't been on the money tonight.
Whip around the corner and that races away for four more. Christopher Henry Gale, take a bow, because there's another half century for Don't Blush Baby. She's at home chilling while he's smoking it to all parts. Coaching staff love it. 51 from 22, 8 done, it's 72 for none.
So 22 required from 72 deliveries. Tallawahs in full control. This man, Chris Gale, well, he's playing like a man possessed. Really wants this title. He's raced to 51 off just 22 deliveries. Six hero maximums and three fours.
Yeah, he's certainly been in a hurry today, that's for sure. Had a bit of an inkling he might do this, so there was out of doubt there was going to be no dramas. Take the responsibility himself. Strike rate of 231 in six sixes, three fours. Amazing stuff from Gale.
What do you expect from arguably the best T20 player in the world? Christopher Henry Gale has dominated T20 cricket with the bat. What a player he is.
So wide. A wing and a prayer, I think, for the Warriors tonight. Plans were clearly upset by having to bat first, and you could almost see the delight in Chris Gayle's eyes once he won the toss and inserted them after they did so well chasing. So things topsy-turvy for the Warriors. A cat really thrown amongst the pigeons early. And they never recovered from that moment on. Dominated by the Tallawahs. Our hero fan of the match. Congratulations, sir. Warrior supporter. He's got his weapons. Unfortunately, they didn't fire tonight, though. $500. Down the ground, straight. Just the one. Trotting through by Gale.
When you look back at what Guyana Amazon Warriors have done, you can really feel a bit sorry for them at this stage of the competition. They've played the most consistent cricket throughout this entire tournament.
Oh!
8 wins from 11 matches so far, and they're staring at a defeat in this so important final.
Five off that over, nine overs gone, 77 for no loss.
Wonderful atmosphere here at Warner Park. Chris Gale looks very relaxed. Partnership between himself and Chadwick Walton, 77 from just 57 deliveries, and only 17 runs required for them to lift this CPL title.
Must be Tallawah supporters or tourists who have had a great time. 17 they need from 66 at the moment. That's all it is. What does that equate to? Maybe three blows from Gale? So 54 of 24 balls, 25 balls now for Chris Gale. Here's a look at the work that he's done so far. Six massive sixes. That's how he likes to deal. And he only took about an over of having a bit of a lock, and then he decided to launch.
Just a single again for Walton. When you look at this Tallawahs team, it's a team studded with match winners. Likes of Gale, Russell, Sangakkara. Some real match winners in there. And you can't also forget the support from the local players. Kendrick Williams, he's been excellent with the ball for the Tallawahs.
It's nicely bowled by Emirates. as the Digicel Bring the Beats prize winner wins a phone, $500 US or EC dollars. Mahendra, congratulations. Might be out. Jake has taken the catch. So no celebration there from Red Emirates whatsoever. He's picked up his opposite number, who hit that one right at the bottom of the bat. That's why it didn't launch about 30 seats back.
Well, Chris Gayle was looking at the bottom of his bat. Didn't quite get it off the sweet spot. Good catch by Jacobs. Soft celebration from the captain of the Amazon Warriors. The big man, Chris Gayle, the captain, departs for 54. It's 79 for one.
So two balls short of 10 overs now, so it's an opportunity to have a Buster drinks break. So there's 15 runs needed to win this. In the meantime, we're just going to have a look at the Caravel Batik, which is housed in an historic old plantation house known as the Romney Manor. Lots of wax is involved and dye. Creates colourful designs, which the Caribbean's become famous for. I think those of you who come to the Caribbean, you'll straight away acknowledge all those wonderful colours. Well, that's terrific stuff that they do here in St. Kitts. It really is very sought after batik product. It was established actually in 1974, Caravel Batik. It's one of the many things you can see in St. Kitts. 50 wickets now for Red Emirates and CPL. Kumar Sangakkara off the mark easily on the leg side.
Tallawahs inching closer to victory. The party of Chris Gayle has brought Sangakkara. And he had a soft dismissal in the last match they played against the Trinbago Knight Riders. Sangakkara lofted an easy drive all the way to long off. I'm sure he will not want to make the same mistake.
For one.
So it'll be the second time the Tallawahs will lift the CPL trophy. Won it in 2013.
Kara, Chadwick Walton, Christopher Gill. They were all in that team in 2013. And here they are yet again in 2016. 14 required from 60 deliveries. Paul Nixon, the coach of the Tallawahs team, who was the coach in 2013 when they lifted the CPL trophy. Lots of players are still here from that winning team in 2013. So too Sangakkara played an important part in their triumph in 2013, and here he is yet again featuring. Will be Tanvir. Captain Chris Gill throughout the entire first part of this match. Sangakkara was busy assisting Chris Gill, the captain. Subtle field changes, bowling changes. It's very good behind the stumps as well. Did a fine stumping to dismiss Riyad Emirate.
Gee, what a disappointing night this has been for the Warriors and also their supporters. They've packed in here tonight. Some have travelled, no doubt. There's a reasonable percentage of people that live in Tickets that originated from Guyana. But they certainly haven't had too much to cheer about. Only a dozen required now from a lot of balls. Very one-sided final. Time from one of their star performers throughout the CPL, Tanvir.
They never got going in the first innings. This is what transpired. Their top performer, Smith, he was going for 17. Madison for no score. The big player, Chris Lynn, Shakib got the better of him. Even Jason Mohammed struggled, not even getting off the mark.
Tallawahs, on the other hand, well, they were terrific. They have had some issues with their bowling over the last few games since Stain departed, but certainly not today. Terrific individual performances. They would have known the likes of Len, Maddinson, and also Smith needed to be moved out of the way pretty quickly. They did that. There's Keswick Williams. He's been full of energy and full of wickets as well, which has been pleased to see.
Tallawahs.
Rockman Powell has been a revelation this year's CPL. Young, talented player. Well, with the bat for the Tallawahs.
Cries of catcher, but on the bounce to the skipper. You're going to be seeing a few broad smiles, not too far away. Not from those guys, but from the Tallawahs, the bench. Paul Nixon, the coach. Of course, he was the winning coach when they won the first edition of the CPL. Looks like he's going to do it for the second time. End of the over, 11 gone, 83 for one.
So Tanvir completes his quota of four overs. Just conceded 17 runs. Very rare. You see him not pick up any wickets. Walton unbeaten on 23 of 33. So to Sangakkara, 3 of 6.
So they're still plenty of batting to come, but I doubt if any are going to be needed. Can't see Walton and Sangakkara doing anything silly here with 11 required for 54 balls. a side note to Paul Nixon, looking like being victorious as coach again. I mentioned yesterday he was coach when they won it the first time, and he was given the job again this time when Mickey Arthur had the job with Pakistan. So it was a fairly late swap around, but Nixon's grabbed it with both hands, which is terrific to see.
Struggling a bit here. Just faced 8 deliveries, only scored 3 runs. And he has a lot of time, not being under any immense pressure. There's 11 runs required now for the celebration start for the Tallawahs.
Single. So it's amazing to think back and look at how consistent the Warriors were. And there's no doubt in my mind they were just one of those sides throughout the entire CPL. Every time they fronted up, they got a job done. They played well. They played consistently. They played hard. Things have just all fallen apart dramatically in this final.
Not to mention Martin Goptill, captain before Riyad Emery took over.
Oops, that's an interesting delivery. Apologies from Emirates. And a free hit it's going to be.
Talking about Riyad Emery, had to take over from Martin Goptill. Not be happy with this delivery. Opting for a slower ball and just slipping out his fingers.
I do think, though, and apart from tonight, I think he's, and he had nothing to really play with, because the players in general didn't, as a whole, didn't play well. But I think his captaincy's been good. It's been calm. It's been assertive. He hasn't got flustered. He's, I think you know as well as anyone, Darren, that when you're skipping a T20 side, you can often be under a lot of pressure. You've got to think clearly. You've got to stay with your plans. You've got to make sure that your fellow players can look towards you and know that you've got things under control, even if at times they haven't. And there's no time at all tonight that Red Everett would have thought that it was ever under control, and I'm afraid it really is telling a story now.
They certainly would have missed Martin Goptill with the bat at the top of the innings. He had accumulated 164 runs in his matches played before he departed. It's not easy to be leading a team halfway through a tournament while coming to a final and delivering.
Yeah, and then again, if you've got your star international players, whether they're the likes of Gale, the Andre Russells, Darren Sammies, all those sort of guys, or the star overseas players, those guys play well, those guys add in the environment, it makes a massive difference. And you can often feed off them as well, and it lifts the entire sides. End of the over, 3 from that, 86 for 1.
Handful of runs required now, and the crowd is celebrating. Well, they've been celebrating before a ball's been bowled here in this Hero CPL finale. Buster Band haven't stopped jiving. 8 to get now for the JTs. I'll make that 7. Seen Gale, the Storm has come through St. Kitts and Nevis. 54 from 27, 6 sixes, and that is why he's quite a happy champion.
Yes, he's got the smile out now. You know, second time they'll win the Tallawahs. You say the biggest party in sport, and I think it's going to happen tonight for them. Good piece of fielding. Muhammad, he's been fantastic. Classic catches as well for him. He's been all over it. But the hotel might be pumping tonight, Danny, with all the teams at the Marriott. Tallawahs will be back celebrating. We might have to just pop down there. Pop our head in.
Absolutely. There were bells on. I love it for these guys. Sang as he strolled out to be there at the end. I bet your bottom dollar this guy will want to be there for the winning runs. Three to go. Is this going to disappear? Flat back. Oh, Smithers has missed it, and that's it. The invasion has started from a Jamaica Tallawahs dugout. Celebrations going off here at Warner for the men in yellow and black and green. Paul Nixon, you can better be in the thick of that too. Loves a party, does the assistant coach. Here come the rest of the squad. Huge win, the second. They're in there. We talk about celebrations, El Dorado celebrations. Nothing beats this. The winning feeling. Chris Gale, Paul Nixon, Russell. He got him there with that 100. He got us there with that quickest T20 100 ever. Disappointment for Emran and the Warriors at the moment. Incredible final.
Sure is. All this mayhem. Let's get side down to Mark Howard.
Well, there's a lot of excitement down in the middle. We might try and grab some of the boys. Andre Russell, Jamaica will be cheering tonight.
Of course, I know everyone will be happy back home. We're happy, everyone is happy. You know, I know that we have a lot of supporters back home. And I was going to say, Independence Day was a few days ago, representing.
Congratulations. There's a lot of excitement down here as they're going through and congratulating each other. We might grab this man while he gets a moment. Congratulations. It's been a wonderful night for the Tallawahs.
Yes, great victory. We worked so hard throughout the tournament, so in the end that's paid off. So feels great, obviously, to be on the winning side after working so hard for the last 40 days or something. So, yeah, we're going to enjoy. And tomorrow I have got my flight, so looking forward to it.
Tomorrow's tomorrow. Well done, Shaquem.
Yes, thank you.
Well, we'll continue. We'll grab the coach while we get a moment. Nico, you lost three on the trot. Things were getting away from you. It's a great comeback.
Great comeback. We had belief. We tried a few things. Didn't quite work out for us, but we've got such a great bunch of guys. Backroom staff. Delight for everybody. Absolutely amazing.
Congratulations. There is Chadwick Walton, who was out in the middle. Chadwick, congratulations. It's going to be a big party in Jamaica tonight. What was it like out in the middle when Chris Garr was belting them everywhere?
Well, when Texas belting it everywhere, just go to the stand up next and just admire it.
And in front of this big crowd tonight, you've lost a few games in a row. It's been a wonderful last couple of games for you and the boys.
Yes, I mean, ever since we left Jamaica, we know that we just needed to win two games to win the tournament, and we won the two most important games.
Congratulations. Enjoy the celebrations.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, they had lost a couple of games in a row. We'll continue over here, and there's a man with a bottle of champagne in his hands. Congratulations. A wonderful night.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. It's we're in awe right now. We worked so hard for this. Just coming from playing for the Zooks and coming into this team here, it's amazing. Just the camaraderie and the cohesiveness we have here. I'm lost for words right now. I'm just enjoying myself.
Can you show me some of the dancing we'll be seeing tonight? Well, we better get Kezzy. That's probably Kezzy's man. All right. Kezzy, what do you want to say?
Say something. I want to, you know, to be honest with you, I'm really, really happy. I'm really, really grateful. Mom, this is where you're loving from my heart. My father. My family, my friends, everybody who has supported me back home, Spring Village, Juba, I'm coming home as a champion. I'm thankful, I'm grateful, respect, and I'm going to Kezzy Box to them.
There's Kezzy dancing and prancing. We might make our way over. to the boss of the whole show and just try and get a quick word with Chris Gayle. Chris, congratulations. Firstly, your own innings tonight. It was a wonderful knock and it was a great way to finish off the tournament, big man.
Yeah, great way to finish. I'm so happy. It's actually a relief. I got to commend the guys the way I go about it. And you know, we lost some momentum in the tournament, but the guys picked it up in the semi-final and then came in the final. And then to actually restrict Guyana for 94 runs, you know, it's unbelievable. And then, you know, we finished it off on a strong note as well. So, thank God. I'm happy it's over and I'm happier I actually won the trophy.
You play cricket all around the world. I would imagine coming back to the Caribbean, four straight wins at Sabina Park in front of your home fans. It must be special to win the Caribbean. Look at the smile on the man's face.
Yeah, definitely. Once I say, you know, when we leave Jamaica, I told him actually I'll bring back the trophy, and you know, I didn't disappoint. I'm glad I've done that the second time now. And you know, only we can get bigger and better with the CPL and make sure, you know, at the end of the day, the fans happy. You know, it was a great turnout, so I'm really happy with the result, and we'll try and move on from here.
I'll let you go and join your teammates, but that is a big bottle of champagne. What is the party involved tonight?
A lot of drinking tonight, a lot of drunk guys tomorrow morning. We're going to celebrate all night tonight.
All right, Universe Boss, well done.
Thanks, man. Cheers.
Back to you boys upstairs. Great scenes down here. The Tallawahs have won the 2016 Hero CPL.
Thank you, Mark Howard. Yes, there'll be a long, long party into the wee hours of tomorrow. Champagne shaken and sprayed everywhere. Rightly so. Russell, who's had his ups and downs with injury and form. Some of the owners are out there. Yeah, they're going to party hard tonight. Russell and Gayle with that 54 from 27 deliveries. Smoked it as only he can with that big blade of his. And now the dancing. Got the shoes on, and Powell and Keswick Williams will be in there with Gayle. And Nixon, Paul Nixon, he'll be in there, I tell you. Cutting loose and having a ball. Fitness staff, coaches, owners, they're all in there. Family supporters, you name it. They've enjoyed what has been a rather one-sided final, sure. But you've got to be in to make a performance count, and they sure have the Tallawahs winning the toss, putting in the Warriors, and they battled and are never, ever allowed to get out of second gear, the Amazon Warriors. Gayle, well, he just stepped up and carved into all parts. Started slowly, and now he's making up for lost time. If you're not making it slow tonight, celebrations, dressing room, and then to the hotel.
Yes, get to the hotel tonight. Be all fun and games, champagne popping. Incredible scenes. That's it. Throw it away. It doesn't cost much. Look at that big one. Gayle's always going to have the biggest one. They're going to groove and shake tonight. St. Kitts, better be ready. You don't want to be staying at the hotel night. You're going to get no sleep either. They're going to party all night into tomorrow. Totally deserve their second win in CPL. The first year they took it off. Paul Nixon was coach, and now he came back. All of a sudden, back to the same, and they've pulled off another win. And this will continue. So they open that big bottle when they get on that stage and get their medals and their trophies for the win. Russell, quickest 100 ever, got him into the final. 11 sixes for him. That was the big move. Gayle got a century early on in the CPL as well. Pow. Sangakkara, Steyn, most wickets, left early. Played a huge part at the start of the tournament. And they are just a side full of superstars.
Yeah, repeat of that inaugural final. And the Warriors, for the third time in the Hero CPL, are bridesmaids yet again. They lost that first final in 2013. And then here at Warner Park in 2014, lost to the Tridents. So sadly for the Warriors, very consistent through the round robin. Comes to the finale, they come up short. So you can imagine now the players, a bit of a lap of honour, going to the mound, thanking the fans, thanking St Kitts and Nevis here at Warner Park. Darren Ganga's just popped up from downstairs. Hell of a night.
Yes, gentlemen. An amazing night it will be for the Tallawahs. They played great cricket. Some felt they just went off the boil after their four victories in Jamaica. They've come back very strong. I also feel an amazing century from Andrew Russell. Did really inspire this team, this type of performance that we've seen today.
Coach Nixon, here you go. Don't miss out on the celebrations, yeah. And it's French, eh? Showered with champagne galore here. Wonderful scenes at Warner Park for the Jamaica Tallawahs. A few of you in tears at home. Don't waste. What are you doing? Paul Nixon, my God. Ah, gorgeous. This crowd has stayed behind most of it anyway, because the presentation's going to be down in front of the mound, in front of the big screen here. I've got to say it, it's a tremendous big screen, this here at Warner. Great crystal clear vision for the fans here at this brilliantly intimate ground.
Well, they've created history. The only team to win Euro CPL twice. They're celebrating it with the fans as well, young and old. Everyone, they're all enjoying themselves. What a moment this is for the Tallawahs. And you've got a spare thought too for the Amazon Warriors. They've played some really good cricket, and I know that they've got a big fan base. The disappointment for those fans and, well, the players. Have never expected that type of performance in a final. But there's one team celebrating, Chris Gayle and the Tallawahs.
Yeah, spare a thought for the Warriors. Three finals, 3 seconds. Tough gig, sport, that's what it's about on the day. Been so consistent of the Warriors, but these guys, black and yellow, too many big guns. Came to the party and look at the guys that initiated. I said at the toss and then the pitch report, this side is a little bit dry on the square and the spinners did dominate. Shakib Alassane got 2 for 25 and Mad Wazi 3 for 21 from their full spells. And they initiated the collapse of the Warriors, who ended up being all out for 93 in 16.1 overs. And only Tanvir, really, with a 42 from 37, 6 boundaries, kept them in the hunt a little.
Yeah, the other positive thing about this Tallawahs team will be the performance from young Rockman Paul. He's really defined himself as a young, talented player. He will use the performances from this CPL to springboard his own career. Possibly first-class cricket here in the Caribbean. O'Shane Thomas had the opportunity to debut in T20 matches, pick up his first wicket in CPL. So lots of young players coming through, coming out on show. And Kedrick Williams, he's been exceptional with the ball. Talented fast bowler who really took over from Dale Steyn after he had to go back to South Africa. My oh my, he is celebrating.
And Mark O'Donnell there. He's had a couple of years here with the JTs, all the way from the bottom of the South Pacific, based in New Zealand. Mark O'Donnell spent a lot of time in South Africa. Time up in the Netherlands as well, and Hong Kong. So a lot of these coaches, very global because of this global franchise phenomenon that is 2020 cricket now. Yeah, big smiles to Paul Nixon and co.
Desire, hunger.
Loving it to bits and pieces.
You do it for the right reason. Anybody can do it. It's always about success, winning, brilliantly.
So, the Tallawahs only had to track down 94 to win this. Walt not out 25, Sangakkara not out 12, but Gale, the skipper, got 54 from 27 with six maximums and three boundaries, and they cruised in the end to nail it in 12.5.
And with a low target score of 94, there's not much you can do as a bowling unit. Had to pick up 10 wickets, only Riyad Emrit, the captain, got the prize wicket of Chris Gayle, but no one else. Tanvir, who's usually penetrative at the top of the innings, couldn't quite get a wicket. Conceded 17 runs. Both Jacobs and Zampa, they were expensive as well. So it was a mammoth ask for this Amazon Warriors team to restrict the Jamaicans and try and win this match.
So in summary, Hero CPL final for 2016. Warriors never in it. All out for 93 and just 16.1. Wazim with 3 for 21. Williams 2 for 12. Shakib 2 for 25, the standouts. And in reply, is up to the captain with his other opening partner, Chadwick Walton. Cruised there and Sangakkara, the icing on the cake, 95 for 1 in just 12.5. Quick break, and when we come back, we'll have the presentation. Sangakkara, the winning moment. Slog sweeping it over wide long on, and the celebrations begin for Chadwick Walton, Kumar Sangakkara, and the rest of the Tallawahs. They've won the Hero CPL for a second time, edition 4, and the party has already started. Well, let's go down there to Mark Howard and the post-match presentation.
Thank you, Danny. Well, it has been an incredible 5 or 6 weeks. 34 matches across 7 countries. We get to St Kitts for the final tonight. And congratulations to the Jamaica Tallawahs, who have won their second Hero Caribbean Premier League title. Wonderful crowds here tonight, and a lot of this couldn't happen without our match officials. So they will be the first at the presentation area. It will be presented by the CPL Director of Cricket, Tom Moody. Firstly off, our match referee, Mr. Dev Govinji. Thanks to Dev. Our two umpires in the middle, led by Mr. Leslie Reefer, as well as John Ward out in the middle. Our TV umpire tonight is Mr. Johan Cloti. And our fourth umpire, doing a great job as always, Mr. Wycliffe Mitchum. Thank you very much to our match referees. They've done a wonderful job throughout the tournament. Unfortunately, the Guyana Amazon Warriors, they finished the home and away at the top of the table, and have left it to the final game to put in what has been their, unfortunately, worst performance. They've been led from the front by a wonderful captain by the name of Riyad Emrit, and he will go and have a chat as the Guyana Amazon Warriors come up to receive their medals. These will be presented by the president of the West Indies Cricket Association, Mr. Wavell Hines, and the CPL Chief Operations Officer, Pete Russell. And Riyad makes his way over towards Mike Haseman. He's led from the front. No doubt he'll be disappointed, but he joins Mike now. Mike.
Yes, I've got Red alongside me. Righto, Red. I mean, it was a pretty tough night out there for you guys. But unfortunately, the Warriors have been up three times now, but no trophy. Disappointing evening.
Yeah, first of all, thanks to the Almighty, nothing is possible. It's been a tough game for us. We just didn't put enough runs on the board. Batting first has been our downfall, you know, throughout the tournament. We haven't won a game batting first. And tonight, I don't think that, you know, we're really up for it, batting first. Must say well done to Chris and his guys. They played excellent, and, you know, they deserve to win tonight.
I want to go back to the toss, because you won eight games chasing throughout this edition of the CPL. When you were asked to bat first, how did that upset the plans?
Yeah, we knew we weren't going to win every toss, you know, but it's up to the batters now to get in the mind frame to bat first. I think, you know, we weren't in that mind frame tonight. But, I, you know, it's these things happen, you know, we just have to learn. It's a third final for the Amazon Warriors, and they still can't cross the line. You know, some of the guys are really shattered. I know our owner, you know, he's probably down, but I just want to say thanks to him again, you know, for giving us the opportunity. We're a comfortable bunch of guys, just we didn't pull through tonight.
If we sit back and we just analyse the way the Warriors have played throughout most of the CPLs, they've been consistent, and I think in particular this CPL, one of the things that stands out is you guys had really good steely resolve and you got the job done without any magnificent, outstanding performances. So why do you think it went so wrong tonight?
Yeah, at the beginning of the tournament, no one expected us to be at the finals. You know, we were the underdogs from day one. And I think, you know, what motivated us is that we knew that we didn't have the big names. They said we didn't have the big name overseas players. We gel as a team. You know, the guys really fought hard. We had an excellent camp before the tournament. And I think those things, you know, really pushed us in the end, you know, to reach the finals. But just tonight, it just didn't go away.
And if you look back at the summer, the season, the CPL season, you took over the captaincy, which you did a terrific job, by the way. We all were complimenting the commentary box. How much do you miss Martin Guptill?
Yeah, Martin, you know, he's an integral part of our team. You know, he's one of the best T20 players in the world. You know, Mado came in, he didn't get the scores that we wanted, you know, but that's how it goes. We thought that we have the bunch of guys to do the job. I have a bunch of guys there who will go there and fight for me, and that's what they want as a captain. So I must say, you know, we're happy that we've been in the final. Yes, we're disappointed that we lost, but, you know, hats off to the guys throughout the tournament, you know, for the effort.
And we appreciate your time. Brad, bad luck tonight, but thanks for your time.
No problem. I just want to say thanks to the crowd for the support. I know they're really disappointed as well back in Guyana, but, you know, we love you guys and we play for you guys, hopefully next year.
Thanks to Ryan. And well done to the Guyana Amazon Warriors. They've been fantastic throughout the tournament. There has been some amazing Republic Bank Classic catches throughout this tournament. To hand over the award for the best catch of the tournament is the manager of Group Corporate Communications, Tisha Lee. And the winner of the Republic Bank Classic Catch of 2016, off his own bowling, Keswick Williams. Fantastic effort from Keswick. He's dancing all the way to the stadium. 17 wickets as well. And there is a man who certainly enjoys his cricket, and I dare say will enjoy his evening later on. Well done to Keswick. There's been some wonderful celebrations as well throughout the tournament, El Dorado style. We saw a package earlier on, and everyone has been enjoying the players in the middle. It's time to welcome the chairman of El Dorado, Mr. Kamal Samaru, to present the award to the El Dorado celebration winner, the man whose heart stopped and his teammate got it going again, Andre Russell! And just moving nicely on his way up to get the awards. Great to have El Dorado on board again this year. And the heart is getting started of Andre Russell, Dre Russ. The next award tonight is presented by the Minister of Tourism, the Honourable Lindsay Fitzpatrick Grant. Force and kids, what a great job that must be, because it's not hard to sell this part of the world. The Hero Maximum Award winner for the most sixes with 37, including plenty tonight, the Universe Boss, Chris Gayle. Plenty more sixes tonight, leading from the front, made 100 earlier on in the tournament.
Chris Gayle takes the Hero Maximum Award winner. We'll keep Lindsay Fitzpatrick Grant up there again to present the Hero of the League. This man, 286 runs, striking at 173, 11 wickets at 19, and two nights ago, 100 off 42 deliveries with 11 sixes. He's alive again, Andre Russell! It's been a dominant performance by the big man. Got the early wicket of Nick Mattinson tonight. Wasn't required with the bat. Dre Russ, we might get you over and have a chat with Mike Haseman. The world needs to hear from Superman from Jamaica as he walks in to join Mike Haseman. Mike.
Andre. Congratulations. I want to know, is there anything else you want to do? You got married a week ago, you got the fastest CPL 100, you recovered from a bad leg in the space of a couple of days, and now you got this award. Anything else you want to do?
I think they seal it off. You know, I have an amazing team. You know, I think they make this even more special for me. You know, getting married and, you know, take another step in my life, you know, it's a very big step. I just want to give God thanks as well. You know, fastest 100 a couple of days ago. I never thought I would actually have a T20 century, but, you know, with God, everything is possible. And, you know, the crowd here have been tremendous. You know, it kind of keep me going. And I just want to say well done to my team. You know, everyone really show class. You know, young Shane Thomas tonight, his first game, and he bowled like a champion. So, you know, when you have a young guy like that, you know, to come, I didn't have to tell him what to bowl, ball by ball, he's delivering, you know. And then, you know, the six machine, Chris Gayle, you know, he sealed it off for us tonight.
Now, when you woke up this morning, what sort of a game, when you played against the Warriors a lot, what sort of game did you expect you guys were going to have?
You know, they beat us twice, and, you know, we planned that we're going to seal the series to all. It's not a bad option, you know, I don't think they will feel bad about it, you know, it's just too all. So none of us actually lost the series, but we win the most important game. So bad luck to Guyana. I just think that, you know, when you're playing cricket and, you know, momentum going and then you get a couple of days rest, that kind of may show you off. So, you know, in the past, you know, it happened to us in Florida, we get like 10 days off and we lost twice, you know, so. Well done to my team again.
Final question. We all still want to know, how did you get that 100 off 42 deliveries?
It's just all about confidence. You know, see ball, hit ball. And, you know, it's a very good wicket that we played on two nights ago. And, you know, I want to know where the party at. I'm in St. Kitts celebrating. Is it karma? Is it on this trip? Well, wherever the party is, that's all we are going.
I have full confidence you're going to find it. Andre, congratulations. Well done, buddy.
Thank you very much.
It is the biggest party in world sport, and I think the Tallawahs are pretty keen to get going. We're not too far away from handing over the overall trophy. But first, the Digicel player of the match tonight, presented by the operations manager of Digicel Play, Mr. Justin John, and the chairman of the Tallawahs, Mr. Manish Patel. This man, very economical throughout the tournament, got wickets tonight with 3 for 21. Imad Wazim! A fantastic performance, and the team chairman, Manish, seems pretty happy with Imad's work. Fantastic throughout the tournament with ball in hand. He's a great batsman as well. Didn't get that opportunity tonight. When you're done there, Imad, we might get you down to have a chat with Mike Haseman, one of the most, if not the most, economical bowlers in the tournament, with 3 for 21 tonight, and a CPL champion. Joining now, Mike Haseman.
Yeah, thanks, Howie. Imad, let's start with that. I mean, your economy rate was 5.8 throughout the entire tournament. I mean, how did you bowl so consistently and so economically?
Oh, I just go on and what I did is, I just ball wicket to wicket, and whatever the captain told me and the coach told me, I just do my best.
This is your first CPL, no doubt. You've thoroughly enjoyed it.
Oh, yeah, it's beautiful. It's a great island. I've never been to Caribbean, so it's a wonderful island, wonderful team, wonderful management, so I loved it.
So in all the franchise and the teams you've played around the world with, how was this so different with the Tallawahs?
I think in our team, there are so many good players. You know, they're most of them the legend of the game. You know, Sanga, Gale, and Steyn, Russell, Shakib, you know. So I just learned a lot from them. And obviously, if you're running in international cricket or even in the leagues, you just have to learn how to adopt the condition and stuff. So they told me different stuff. And the coach and the management, they were really good to me.
Well, you certainly did your role tonight in winning the trophy. Man of the match, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
The Jamaica Tallawahs won four straight games at home at Sabina Park. Then they lost three in a row, a couple in Florida, and then won the last two games of the tournament, the two most important games. I will get Chris Gayle to come up last, but first we'll invite his teammates to come up and to receive their medals. They'll be presented by the Deputy Prime Minister of St Kitts and Nevis, the Honourable Sean Richards, and the CPL CEO, Damien O'Donoghue. So, one at a time. With Chris Gayle last, if the Tallawahs could make their way onto the stage to receive their medals.
Well, they're just so excited. No one who wants to come up first. Too much celebrating from the JTs. Williams here, the dancers on. Wonderful occasion. These Jamaica Tallawahs having to go the longer distance, the longer route to the final by knocking over TKR. That very, very long marathon of a match here on Friday with all the weather around. They've weathered that storm and then brought their own storm. Here to St Kitts and Nevis, Warner Park. And had an exceptional final against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Squad, most have got a game over this pretty much 6 weeks of the Hero CPL. Shakib there, a couple of wickets tonight. Sangers, who have the icing on the cake. Superman, Dre Russell, time of his life, just got married and winning the Hero CPL for a second time. Backroom staff need them to get these gentlemen back on the park, fit and furious and ready to go for this fabulous format that is 2020 cricket. Coaches and support staff alike, this powerful franchise out of Jamaica. Paul Nixon back in the thick of it. He was here in year one, of course. And now, dark and stormy. Christopher Henry Gayle. High fives there. Damien O'Donoghue and co. And he'll to get over there and make his way. The winning captain of the Hero CPL for 2016 with Michael Haseman.
Thanks, Danny. I got Chris alongside me. Righto, Skipper. Two CPL trophies now. What does this mean to you? You've played with franchises all around the world. How special is this?
It's very special, coming from a captain point of view as well, to actually win it a second time. You know, first I want to thank God for this, to be able to actually, you know, get right through the CPL. You know, it's been struggling with a few injuries here and there, but I managed to pull through, so I'm very thankful for that. But, you know, it's right up there as well, you know, from the first one, so I'm very thankful to actually, you know, win it the second time around.
So why do you think your campaign this year, and you did it the hard way, why do you think your campaign this year was so successful?
We play good cricket as a unit, you know, but first I want to come in Guyana. They have been the number one team, the third time making it to the final as well, but just want to say unlucky to them, but it was a great game and, you know, just unfortunately on the losing side. But from my team point of view, you know, I thought we played brilliant cricket, especially at home, but, you know, we lost the momentum, you know, in Florida when we lost two games in a row. And, you know, we came here and then we lost against Guyana and then, you know, we said, listen, we can't lose four games in a row. So, you know, to be able to actually win against Trinidad and then, you know, the momentum was actually with us in the final. You know, just want to thank the players who gave me the support right throughout the tournament as well. I want to also thank the management staff, you know, for the support. They actually played Dale Steyn is not here, and I also want to thank Dale Steyn as well. So it's been a great bunch of guys, and you know, we enjoy each other's company, which is actually fantastic.
And lastly, I'm looking at the keeper. You guys are celebrating, you do. You've had some fanatical support around the CPL. What about your support in Jamaica?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, you know, when we depart Jamaica, you know, I told them, you know, I'm not coming back home without the trophy. So Jamaica, this is another one from Chris Gayle and the team. So we see what happens next year. You never know. But I just want to comment each and every one of the fans who actually turned out tonight. It's been fantastic. Hopefully, you know, it can be even, you know, bigger, better year. And it's a possibility I might try to change things and play for St. Kitts next year.
Chris, thanks for your time. Congratulations. Go and grab that champagne.
Oh, thank you so much.
We'll let Chris move up onto stage to join the COO of the Hero Caribbean Premier League, Mr. Pete Russell, and the CEO, Mr. Damien O'Donoghue. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 Hero CPL champions, the Jamaica Tallawahs!
Biggest party in sport, that is for sure. The Hero Caribbean Premier League, the fourth edition, has come to an end, and it's the Jamaica Tallawahs again. Won it in year one, here in year four, they've got their hands all over this trophy again. Time to celebrate long into the night here in St. Kitts and Nevis. Loved it here at Warner Park again. Finals were here in 2014, they're here again in 2016. And it's the JTs with their inspirational captain and some superstar talent in this franchise, as well as the backroom crew doing wonderful things to keep these guys on the park. And winners are grinners. They'll be taking all those accolades, all that love and vibe and music well into the 8th of August. It is still the 7th of August here in the Caribbean on the eastern side. It's brilliant here to be part of, and from all of us here, bringing it to you in your homes, we've had an absolute joy of a time. Love coming to this unique part of the world that is the Caribbean. And the music, history, and the love of the game. And that's what it's about, the love and the passion for the game of cricket. And it's alive and well here in the West Indies, having won the World T20 recently in India. And they have their own simply brilliant tournament that goes for a little under 6 weeks. It is a joy and an honour to be part of. So all these photos we beamed around the globe in coming hours, all the media outlets to soak up the Jamaica Tallawahs and what they've achieved here. Congrats big time to Christopher Henry Gale and his team. Lots of sponsors' products about to flow even more here in St. Kitts and Nevis. So the trophy's going to be handed around all night. Paul Nixon here gets his hands on it again, 2013, and now 2016 for the JTs. DG, been a heck of a tournament, loved it.
It's been wonderful entertainment. I think must underscore Chris Gayle and his leadership. He's been excellent for the Tallawahs. And a lot
lot of people felt they were down and out and qualified as second. It has come true and really brought joy to the Tallawahs and lots of people who support them.
Well, they're at the side with all the superstars in it. They won all their home games in Jamaica and then a bit of a trouble in Florida. They had 10 days no cricket. Chris Garn mentioned that, so they wanted to keep playing. They turned up here in fine form. Russell, Sangakkara, Steyn was here earlier. Powell as well. It's been an outstanding unit. Paul Nixon leading from the top, coaching. Built the squad into one that's full of confidence and that talent just comes out. Not all the time because of Chris Gayle. Well, it's been backed up by a lot of players this tournament.
Again, they lost to the Warriors, don't forget, in playoff one on Wednesday night here. So they allowed the Warriors to go straight through into the finale. But they've won the game that mattered. Lost on Wednesday for sure to the Warriors, but now getting through and taking on TKR on Friday and got over that hurdle and allowed them to keep playing and get that momentum back. Play here in the grand final on Sunday evening, August the 7th here. A lot of energy, Paul Nixon, and he brings that to the Tallawahs squad. And they've had a heck of a time. There's certainly ebb and flow for them. No surprises, there'll be a few selfies taken with the captain. Surrounded with the Buster crew. The crowd have been entertained even though it was short and sweet. And got to see their heroes up close and personal here at Warner Park in St. Kitts and Nevis. Wonderful tournament. We've enjoyed ourselves immensely. And until 2017, we'll do it all again then.
We have the hand from your one number one. From your ready for the competition. Yeah. You not take intimidation. Yeah. Woman and man. We have the hand. Yeah.
This is how we play the game.
This is how we play.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And we gon' represent and show them who we stand for.
We stand for.
Every pitch, every pad, every bill, every wicket, every stone. And the heart and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood.
It's how
when
we play.
When come out our nation, be the team in a unification. When the stadium ram beach at the grandstand, and the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.